What's up, guys? What's happening? Happy Thursday. We made it. All right, let's get some tunes going. My goodness, I am in such a mood to play this game. Holy smokes. And I got so worried this morning. Oh goodness, I woke up a little bit early to try and record, but I finally found, you know, like the straw that like breaks the camel's back kind of thing. Oh my goodness, I'll explain in a sec. Hey, what's going on? So JBS, we got Dan's here, Panda's here, Space Nut, Shaggy Dog. What's going on, guys? Hope you guys are doing well today. Thanks for making it out. But yeah, this morning I was like going through the workshop again, and I was just downloading a whole bunch of new assets. Oh my goodness, too many. My total count got up to 1,467. And then basically every time I would load the game, after that it would just crash. So I kind of had to scale back. So here we are. So most of the ones I downloaded recently are unfortunately gone. But oh my goodness. Oh, I know the range. That was pretty wild. The Rangers fight. I don't even have to say to that. And that was apparently a little bit of beef based on like the whole, you know, bat flip thing from the you know, from last year's whole events. Oh goodness, politics and baseball, right? Too funny. Hey Dora, thanks for stopping by. All right, guys. So for today, I kind of actually before things start, let me point out some stuff I changed. I was kind of going through the city, and I changed like, you know, just like a few. Where's a good example? Can't even think of one now. Well, like this kind of stuff, right? So I changed this around, like some of the trains where they kind of connect, some of the roads. Like this thing here is a little bit different now, just to kind of make traffic flow a little better. Actually, I need to change this before I forget. Oh, and I didn't change the speeds over here too. Oh goodness. I wonder if people are driving so slow. So that's what happens when you get a little bit distracted. Oh, you missed the intro? I don't know. Maybe it's on my end, because my internet's not the best, but I'm looking at my drop frames and I seem to be okay for the moment, but I don't want to jinx it now, because last time I jinxed it way early, so. I mean, but in general, I don't know. I mean, Twitch has its moments too where uploading is not really as smooth as, right? Okay, so that is sorted. Hey there, Yob 180. Oh no, buffering 2 minutes? Oh, holy smokes. Hope that. Yeah, it's kind of weird. Some of you are having great connections, others not so much. From my end, it seems like it's okay. I'm not really getting any drop frames, so. Maybe it's a Twitch end thing, so we'll give it a minute or two. Won't really jump into anything too crazy. So this is kind of fun, right? I added a traffic light here, just to kind of, you know, connect these two areas. And I elevated this train the whole way through. And then I was thinking of actually making this into like an elevated bypass. But there's actually quite a bit of traffic that kind of piles into each other. But I just love the way that the light kind of times traffic. So it's like the roundabout's empty, and then, you know, the light changes and then the roundabout's full. I kind of like that. That's kind of fun. Oh, and you can't change the quality either? Yeah, I don't understand what's up with that. Like, from my... I have the options panel to do it on, like, my... Like, if I load the stream, right? But on my, like, dashboard thing, I don't really have, like, an option, per se, to kind of change that kind of stuff around. So I'm not 100% here. Oh, yeah, Traffic President, it does something with these trains. I have no idea if this is, you know? I think maybe at junctions there might be... Oh, cool, you can change speeds? Or... No, that's underground. That's an underground thing. So I have no idea. Maybe Traffic President has nothing to do with trains. It just recognizes those as trains. Maybe that's kind of, you know? Maybe that's kind of what's going on. Okay, so I want to pause it, and I'm going to delete this. Unfortunately, delete it. And actually, maybe we don't have to delete it. Maybe we can keep that aspect of it. I don't know. That's a little bit wonky, right? We can do that again. And the goal is just to do, you know, something like this, right? Just where there's like an overhead bypass, I guess, whatever you want to call it. Oh, fiddles, these things don't line up. Oh, of course not. Too funny. They look like signal blocks. Yeah, they do. So maybe we can change them. I'm not 100%. That's a little bit cleaner. So the roundabout, I guess, has to be around here. And it has to be big enough to kind of get that going and to avoid, hopefully, that pillar. Okay. Now that we know all this, we'll go to say here. And we'll make. but kind of like a Y-shape approach, so it's not necessarily going to be, you know, like this, but... We'll see if we can get this in one little stabby. Okay, so let's go, say, actually, can we fit a 7 in here? Probably not, right? No, just, oh, wait, what? We maybe, oh, no, we can't. Let's do 6. That would have been cool, though. I don't know why. I just like that number. Okay. Hey there, Pertlick. How are you doing today? Thanks for stopping by. Yeah, the city, it's come along rather nicely, eh? Truck traffic around train stations, or truck traffic to a train station. If you're talking about an industrial one, that's actually what we got going on over here. What I tend to like to do, where's a good example? Maybe this is not the best example, but traffic, it wants to come in like this and then leave like that. So hypothetically, if you make this into a one-way corridor, not a lot of room to kind of do that here. That's a better way to kind of get traffic going. Maybe I did something like that over here. I did not, but let me show you what I mean by that. Oh, maybe we did over here, yes! Right, so you can kind of see like the cargo terminal, it's off on its own separate little road. This road here is a two-lane one-way. Don't let that center median thing kind of fool you. I'm just using some traffic mods right here. And yeah, a few of you are saying that the buffering, that's so strange, eh? Because I've only dropped 0.04% of frames, so it's actually pretty decent. And my connection's bouncing between 4 and 6 megs for the upload. So I really have no idea. Maybe it's on Twitch. I really have no idea. Okay, so here we go. Back over here. So keeping truck traffic separate, what we have is a bypass. That way we don't have to worry about trucks kind of, you know, crossing in front of each other. And then the goal is just to get them back to the highway rather quickly. This area is a little bit unique, but... Something like that is a good way to kind of, you know, balance truck traffic just in general. So keep a traffic, or keep a highway close. And then if possible, try and convert the trucks over to trains. So if you have your trucks hit a cargo station. So like what we're doing, or we were kind of doing this in the last stream, we're going to kind of continue now too. Is this cargo station right here is actually connected to this one over here as kind of like an internal cargo system that we're starting. And then that saves all the trucks from having to drive from you know, one area to the next. So we still have a little bit of, you know, manufacturing and some forestry up here. So we're just kind of experimenting with that, but that's also a cool way to kind of deal with trucks. Oh, no problem, Natsu. Yeah, traffic definitely is, it's always a big headache. And JBS, let me see what you're linking me here. Maybe I have these. Oh, needs! Oh, okay, I'm gonna subscribe to this now. Or actually, no, wait, hold on. Maybe I won't, because I have to test it afterwards, right? Because I was just saying that, like, my, you know, my internet... Oh, I think I might actually have the Air Canada sign, actually. Okay, I'll keep those off to the side. But yeah, all the amount of assets I have, it was crashing my poor game. It's taking me, like, almost 10 minutes now to load it. Can't even believe it. Okay, so let's finish this. Before I get too sidetracked again. But yeah, we'll be building an airport, actually, pretty soon, which is pretty... That's pretty crazy to think about. Okay, so 6x6. Oh, looks like it just barely fits. Perfect. Now I was thinking of maybe making some. No, I think we're okay. Instead of making like a circle, make kind of like, you know, like what am I trying to say here? Like over here, right? See how we have this the straight points in between our roundabouts. I was thinking of doing something like that over here, but I don't know. I think we're okay. Okay, so let's use our. Two laners. Ooh, that's that saxophone beat again. Oh, yeah! Ooh, I remember this. Oh, roundabouts, yeah. In general, they're such a, like, a lifesaver. Like, you can kind of see why they're so, you know, popular over in Europe. Okay, I might have to take this pillar out. Which is not too hard to do. Okay, so trusty mods. What do I need here? No pillars. We'll take this out a bit further, let's say, and then maybe we can drop that down. So I'll put the pillars back in, because I want a pillar on this side, otherwise it doesn't look too... Oh wait, no, that doesn't make any sense. We want to have a pillar, say, right there. Perfect. The whole point was to avoid pillars. Okay, so I'll take 12 units to go down, like that. That works for me. Center Island Airport? Yeah, we can probably do something like that. Let's kind of sneak a peek. Maybe there's some areas will kind of speak to us. Oh, I'm loving this, like, big band kind of sax thing. I do, actually, as a matter of fact. I'm using currently a 25 tile mod. There is an 81 tile mod available, but I really haven't tried that out. You have to have like a really like good computer. I think my computer is fine for it, to be honest. I just don't know if I can run it with the amount of assets I have. But yeah, the default game, you get 9 tiles, which is, what is this, 6, 7? This is 7 right now, so we would put 2 more on, and that would be how much you get if you just buy the game without any mods. You don't have to buy mods, so maybe I should phrase that differently. If you download a free mod, you can unlock 25 tiles. So we're going to be, like, you know, much bigger than this. So I'm excited for that. And then if you want 81 tiles, that literally is, like, from the fog lines inward, so it's, like, as big as you can get. That's like, holy smokes, that'll take you like a month to kind of fill up, you know? That's pretty fun. Okay. Where are we going? Oh, that's right over here. I keep getting so sidetracked. So let's put this in. Oh, I'm so lost in this music. I love it. Okay, so that goes like that. We might maybe distort the shape of the roundabout slightly. I hope not. And then, because the game is silly, and people will totally do it, we're going to have to change the lane arrows here, because literally people are going to drive there, which is so, so silly. Okay, so that's 2 lanes pouring in, that's perfect. That works. And then we'll do the same thing kind of over here. Awesome. Oh, the extra tiles, well, you start off with just the 1, obviously. And then it's just based on your population milestones, so you can kind of see if I, oops, wrong direction. If I back us up, so the first one, right? Seems like so long ago we unlocked this, right? There we go, just 440 people. You just start unlocking, like, you know, some services and some loans and, like, that kind of stuff, right? Because the whole point of the game, especially if you're a little bit new or haven't played in a while type thing, or even when you're starting off a smaller, you know, like a new city without, you know, the money mods, it's good to kind of start slow and just kind of, you know, just keep it at a good pace. Otherwise, things kind of get out of control. So it's not really until, like, level 3 that you unlock your next tile. And then you can kind of see, like, it's every other one, you know, unlock another one, and then see right here another one, probably after this. And then we're almost at the point where we get the rest of them. You kind of just hit that. And so that's the way the mod is written, once you get to, like, level whatever, past the default ones. If you want to, though, you can just play where it's all unlocked right off the get-go. I prefer a little bit more of a challenge, which is why I kind of do this. Is this music a little bit too loud, guys, or is it okay, or... I'll let my enthusiasm and love for it kind of, you know? I hope you guys can hear me over it. Okay, so... Oh, draw the prop line! It is so cool. So it's really, really, really early in its stages of development. Show you an awesome example, though. So if I'm doing, say, like a highway that's like really close together like this or whatever, but I wanted like a prop, you know, a barrier, you know, or whatever, like a divider in between, that's basically what this thing is for. So currently there's only one type of asset or whatever. Oh gosh, how do I get in here? Wait, where is it? It's really buggy, so it doesn't work 100%. Oh, maybe I took out, oh gosh, no, don't tell me I did. Okay, there we go. Oh, they updated it. Oh, okay. So, this was what we were hoping for. Now any asset I take, I can draw a line of them. Oh my gosh, this is just blowing my mind right now. Oh, this is so cool. You can kind of see, though, it must have just been recently updated because it's a little bit, you know, not really working too well. So initially it was just like a kind of like a center median for highways when it first came out. Well, here, let's see this, right? So this you just make, you know, lines of props, which is like absolute gangster, right? So now when you're doing like custom, you know, farms or houses or any of that kind of stuff, right? So that's really cool that it's actually all the props now. So I didn't even know that. That must have been like updated in the last day or two. But the idea is you know, you put like trees or hedges or fences or whatever you want, right? And you just get a nice straight line. So like this kind of thing we could achieve now just using that that prop thing. Which is really cool, I think. And then I don't think I have the link while I'm in the game, but you should be able just to do a search in the workshop, I think just under draw prop line. Okay, so back over to here. Let's kind of continue with our little, you know, our little project. Perfect. Oh, Miss Useless, what's going on? Alright. Now, can we get that nice little curvies with these, or do we have to go a little bit further back? Probably have to go further back if I know this game. Yeah, it's like a barrier placer, exactly. And it, I mean, really, that must have just been in the last like day or so that they've added the, oh gosh, no! Oh, that's terrible. They added the other element to it. Why is this so uncooperative? Maybe this gives me a chance, though, to do, kind of the different size roundabout. That's kind of why I wanted to do it, because, like, it avoids, like, this kind of stuff from happening, right? So let's try that again. And, now that we have no, pillars here, I think we can go up to 7. Which should give us, I think, the right kind of space. Then maybe we can change that around, too. But again, this is the kind of stuff, it's, I want to just get it done, you know? Might as well do it now, right? Okay, so 7 by 7. Cool. Oh, wait! I already caught myself. Silly. Okay, so just give ourselves maybe a 4 right here. Perfect. And then 7 by 7. And then the goal of this is just to kind of give us a little bit more space when we're kind of connecting those little cool Y-shaped kind of feeder roads onto the other, you know, the other guys. There we go, that's better. Well, that's a big roundabout. And then these things here, they're prime for parks, or whatever else you want to put in the center zone. Maybe we'll keep it a bit of a longer approach. Yeah, that's what I'm after. Ooh, yeah. I can almost feel, like, a snap point right there. Oh, there we go. I was like, what did I just mess up? There, that's better. Yeah, you know, the slope of the hill isn't really helping the old cause here. It'd be really cool if we, because I remember when the, what was it called? The Fine Heights mod was in place. You could tunnel underground in increments of, like, 3 meters. Instead of just going 12 for your first one. So I miss those days. Because then I was going to say we could do like a partial, you know, sink part of this or whatever, but I don't think it's going to work. That kind of create headaches. Do we have to move this again? Oh, goodness. Maybe we can cheat and just kind of get close. Yeah, that's fine. And I really want to start using the no pillars mod again. It's just like, I'm just so... Especially for the bigger cities we're working on, you know, on the YouTube channels, right? It's like, it's just so much effort to have to go through the whole city and just erase everything. Oh my goodness, I'm thinking about that right now. Oh boy, oh boy. Oh, you told me to put in the X? Okay. And let's connect that like that. That works for me. And then we're gonna use the traffic president thing again to kind of switch the speeds around. Hey there, what's going on? Oh yeah, Nick, what's going on? Or Nikki, I should say. I'll get your name right at the time. How are things with you? Happy Thursday. And hello to everyone else who's just jumped in. Hope you guys are having a great day. Almost the weekend. Almost made it. And it's a long weekend too if you're in Canada, which is always fun, right? So, no work on Monday. Party. That means I'll probably have some more time to record this weekend. And I do plan on doing a stream on Sunday, so just in case you guys have to bail early or whatever the case is today. Or if you just can't get enough and you want more, then we'll have another stream on Sunday. Okay, so I want to connect this without being too horrifyingly intrusive. And, I mean, that's not the worst, right? We'll keep an eye on this, because this could not be the best angle, but we'll see. Change our lane arrows here. Oh, the holiday for us, it's actually Victoria Day, so it's kind of like Canada's little tribute to the Queen. So we all, you know, light fireworks and have the day off and just kind of hang out. But see, it's like an old traditional holiday, you know? But we'll take any day off we can, right? And in Canada, we like our monarchy, you know? We're cool with the Brits. I think it's kind of fun. And like the Queen and everything, she's on our banknotes and stuff, right? Not all of them, but like, you know, just some of them. And she's on the back of most of our coins too, which is cool. Actually, it's kind of fun. A lot of people will post sometimes to Reddit, because the Queen's on a lot of money, right? But you can kind of see her age if you look at different countries' currencies over the years, which is kind of cool. Okay, so now we've got this part all connected. All we need left is the up and over bypass, and hopefully we can do this well and then still connect everything else. Okay, so we're gonna have to be creative, and I think we're gonna have to maybe connect that one, just because of how this intersection is, over to the intersection. But I think over here we're gonna be able to do something kind of neat with the way that kind of approaches. Okay, so let's bring this down. Now, the only thing is these won't be even just because of the way this intersection here is set up. Now, there's nothing stopping us from just moving this. We don't actually have to have it there. So why don't we make that a little bit more even? This 12 units, I think we used on the other side. There, that goes like that. And that means we're actually going to back these up to where the ramps kind of start. Just kind of change things around a little bit. Oh, you're born in Victoria? No way! You know, I've actually been there. I drove there. I've been on this epic, like, driving, like, a few years ago. So the other guy I share the channel with, Sean, you've probably seen some of his videos. He does more of, like, the vlogging style stuff on the channel. Anyway, him and I just went on this, like, epic road trip across, you know, Canada and America a few years ago. And we ended up in Victoria, and we rented scooters, and we just cruised around all day. It was so much fun! And, like, I don't know, it's just such a beautiful place. Like, I'm always just so shocked at how different Canada is, you know? Okay, so what I'm doing here is not necessarily going to work simply because of the fact that we don't have this kind of thing happening, right? So what we could do for the sake of making things really interesting and without having to change too much is we could do like a partial clover leaf that comes in from over here and then links up to the roundabout, say, on this side, just for, like, you know? Just for the sake of making things kind of different, you know? Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the buffering. I know a few of you have been making that comment as well. Still on my end, I've only dropped 0.06% of frames so far since the stream started. And I'm still, you know, it's like right now it's like between 4 and 6 megs for the upload speed. So it's still kind of, it's doing its thing. So maybe Twitch is having an off day, I don't know. Okay, let's try something interesting here, because I don't really try this kind of stuff too often. So I'm going 14 by 14 on each side, just to make this kind of even. And I still haven't 100% figured out what it is we're actually doing here. But what I think we're going to do is, this will be two-lane road. And this is going to be kind of like I said, a bypass. But it's just going to be, I don't know, is this weird? I feel like we should have a way underneath. Oh gosh, we're going to make this so much more complicated than it has to be. No, this is getting ridiculous. We're going to back this up. I'm literally putting an end to this right now. Oh gosh. Yeah, I don't know, maybe if you guys try hitting refresh or something, I don't know. Okay, so I think the answer is to actually change this, even though we just rebuilt this. Okay. No, you know what we could probably do is just maybe free draw this. Or, oh, I know what we can do, since we are looking for symmetry, right? Is we'll just use our previous post here. Okay, so I want to go out, let's say by 3. So this is actually going to be a really big roundabout. Holy smokes here. I'm going to go by 2. Okay, so go by 2. We're going to do 6 by 6. That should be enough. I'm going to go up by 4. That means it's going to be like a little bit disproportionate. I'm going to lower this part of the curve. That way we're still now keeping our symmetry. Okay, so 6 by... So hopefully that should go underneath if everything goes to plan. Oh gosh, no, do it! What I'm trying to do right here is just get it so that we don't have to... Yeah, we do, darn it. Oh no, this is so much effort. Oh gosh, why do I do this to myself? Okay. Starting the whole thing essentially from scratch again. Which is not the end of the world, it's just going to take me a few extra minutes here. Okay, that's not you. So bear with me guys, but we'll have fun doing this, and it'll be kind of cool I think in the end. It's just taking me a little bit longer than I thought. But after this, I wanted to maybe move over to our kind of shipyard, like the harbor area. And I wanted to work on put it into like a train yard type thing. Like, we have the startings of one, but we only have like two big of ones, so I kind of want to work on that as our next little goal. Okay. There, this is starting to come together a little bit more. And these things, they're never easy, you know? I always think they're going to be pretty simple whenever I start them, but... Actually, now we're going by six. And then six by six. And then since we have all this extra room now with the roundabouts, I'm thinking we might maybe connect... is this a six as well? Oh, it was. We might maybe connect this little back, back street. Okay, so we'll back the pillars up on this as well. Just turn those off right there. Perfect. And then just complete this for the... What feels like 25th time, probably the second time, though. It's not so bad, right? So, I mean, it's interesting infrastructure. Like, it's, we'll kind of see how this ends up looking. But I think we're going to be effective with what we're trying to do here. Okay, so let's go... where's our slope going to start now? I think we have a little bit more room to play with than we have before. Okay, so let's go up over here. I'm going to go by 9. I don't want to be too tall. We'll connect this over to here. That's perfect. And then I did want to have a connection here. And as crazy as it sounds, I did want a set of traffic lights. Because it's... I mean, the whole goal of this is not really to be a highway. It's more of like a national road that's like two lanes. And so those sometimes have, you know, traffic lights and that kind of stuff, right? So that's kind of my reasoning, my logic right there, right? So... I remember to drink this coffee. I always stare at it and I'm like, oh, drink some, and then I forget. Coffee's so good. But only when it's warm. I have this like ongoing, you know, conversation. It's coffee, it just goes through different temperatures and then different degrees of, you know, deliciousness. Okay, so how are we gonna connect this whole, you know? Maybe this can come in. Oh yeah. Oh, okay. So that can go like this, and then we can two-laner like such. Oh, look at that. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, this will be really cool. Oh, man. Very cool use of the space. Okay. Now, that's really neat. Why don't we do this more often, right? These giant kind of, like, I don't know what to call this. It's like a squared roundabout almost. Like, that's a weird kind of cool shape, right? Kind of fun, though. Okay, so we can do a similar connection over on this side. Hopefully not going to damage the shape too much. And the whole goal of this is just to kind of encourage fast transfer, you know? But we have a bypass, which is kind of fun too. Okay. Now, are we going to have... Might as well. Set up something like this, right? Yeah, why not, right? Now, would you have a way on, though, one like this? Or would you force people to go through, maybe the back way? Interesting. I think we're maybe going to keep that as it is. Yeah, cold coffee, I can't do it. I don't know what it is. It's just not really my thing, you know? I don't mind heating back up. I know some people are kind of against that, right? Okay. So this seems to be something that kind of works. I might put another set of traffic lights in over here. I know it's kind of taboo again, and we may take them out. Just the goal is to have a nice, you know, smooth kind of flow through of traffic, but not, you know, put all these roads or trucks on the in on the city roads, right? Okay, so let's just double check all the lanes are going proper direction. I know we don't have an off right here, so that's going to be kind of an issue. It's almost like this should be. Let's try something unique here. Oh wait, we can do that actually. Okay, that still works for me. Okay, yeah, that's not so crazy. It's just like with all the merging, right? It's the only thing that kind of makes me a little bit nervous, you know? And then this, is this crazy? This is probably crazy, right? This has become like a little bit nuts. So let's change some of this. Everything's kind of a test, right? I know we're kind of pushing our limits right here, but we'll kind of see. Okay, I think if we change our lane arrows, we're good. Because I want this one to be only going straight, not turning right. But I don't know if what the lanes are going to say, right? Because those are both kind of right turns. Okay, I think we have to kind of leave that like that. Okay, before this gets too much more chaotic, I think we're okay like that. Okay, so speed on. Let's use the traffic president to change our speed limits so that people kind of, you know, can move through this area rather quickly. Okay, so 100. Seems like there's a road underground here. Am I mistaken? Oh, there is. Well, how about that? Oh, I must have... Oh, I know. Yeah. I must have deleted that last little connection point. So let's just go like that and just bring this out. Let that kind of do its own thing over here. And that may not even be the final spot for that, you know? Just kind of let that just do its thing. Okay, so speed limits. Back up to 100, please. Perfect. And I'm tempted to change our inner road to possibly a three-laner, but we're going to monitor this, because this is really a big test. Because I don't normally make something this kind of, you know, I don't want to say confusing, but this is just a little bit not what I normally do. I guess it's a good way to kind of word that. But so far, so good. Like, we haven't really, you know, no big headaches. Knock on wood, right? Knock on wood, yeah. Oh, gosh. Okay, let's make sure I don't miss anything here in that glare. Oh, gosh. Maybe the inner road should be 80, because these people look like they're going really, really fast through them. Okay. Yeah, let's do that. See, just wherever they merge, that's what kind of makes me a little bit nervous, but that's really not so bad, all things considering. And I know there's a way to set up, making, like, you know, yield lanes, that kind of stuff, with, Traffic President. I haven't actually tried that, though, so I don't know if I want to spend, you know, too much time now trying to figure it out, but stuff that we can kind of consider, you know, or I can try just off camera. Okay. So that is fine. I don't necessarily want people... I guess I don't have a choice, right? I don't want people turning left here. Okay, so let me change that too. Last thing, and then we'll start doing some more building. So no left turns there. Only straight, please. Oh, but there is a traffic light. So why would that be a problem if they turn left? Oh, so it shouldn't be. Forget I said that. Oh, right, it's only when the light... Oh, I see. But no one's really listening to that anyway, so we'll go like that. There we go. Okay, I think that's okay for the moment. Hey there, Bad Fam. Thanks for stopping by. Hope your Thursday's going well. Now, did we change any of the speeds there by accident when we changed that stuff? No, we're okay. Yeah, so it's like all of them... going, like, they're not taking the roundabout to go to the highway, they're going this way and turning left to go onto the highway. That's not really helpful, so I do have to change this, contrary to what I just said. Hopefully people will respect that. And then, if we remove that little bit there that's 100, hopefully people will see that that's a better, you know? Or even if we lower the whole... area here, just to make this less appealing, right? Because yeah, people are still turning left. I can't get them to stop that. Now maybe those people, their path was already chosen before I kind of, you know, did that whole thing right there. Either way, we could probably spend, you know, hours just redoing this, right? But that's not what I want to do. So let's go over here. Bring ourselves some sun, please. Okay, so what I want to do is just fill kind of this whole area in here with kind of like a train yard. Hey there, Hensagon? That's a cool name, actually. How you doing today? So I want to do kind of like a train yard in here, and then just to get a little bit more action on the rails just in general, I want to do a slight bypass with a little skinny, small pedestrian, not pedestrian, but commuter train station here. Let's put that in first and kind of see how much space that'll be. This one has a subway attached to it, so that's not really a bad choice. Don't really have any subway or metro lines in just yet. We can even do one of these guys. It can be a terminal endpoint too, which is pretty convenient actually. So let's do a building that kind of looks like it works well for that. No, that's way too big. Or, you know what we could even do is have it go a little bit further. Oh, this is a nice one. Fits perfectly. Go a little bit further behind and then have the makings of like a commuter rail yard as well. Oh, that'd be kind of fun, right? So if we come like this, can we do a bridge in kind of the same... I think so, right? Okay, let's try that. Oh, then one of you guys, someone linked me this last time. This is really cool. We gotta find a way to make this work. I don't know how the slope and stuff has to be. This is the, what do you connect to even? That's an underground train station there? Oh, I did, eh? Well, that means you do have a unique name, and that means I'm an honest guy. So that's good. Okay. That's kind of fun here, right? So we'll make this continue like such. And then it's just simple placeholder, because we're going to have to, you know, remove the track to put in the new props and everything, but that'll just be 2 seconds from now. And we're going up to, what are we at here? A niner, looks like, even though it was a 10. And then... Okay, I see. We're going to have a uncooperative ground, it would seem. That's okay. We have ways of making you talk. Oh, well, that's not too shabby, right? That, I kind of like that. Yeah, my threats were... Oh, gosh, no. My threats were not enough. I take it back. Oh, darn it. What if we did something bonkers like that? Oh, gosh, no. Okay, so that tells me that we maybe have to move this a little bit further back, which is totally fine. We're just not going to have as much room to work behind it, which is, like, really no problem, you know, when you think about it. Or we can just go under the bridge, that means. Because we can just go like this, right? Or we can play it even safer. We can just go like that, hide the fact that, you know, the little tail kind of sticks out under the bridge. Which I think I like that even more, to be honest. And then do this, and then that way, we now have enough room for a train, or maybe not two trains, but we have enough room for at least one train to buffer without blocking the cargo. Cool. I like it. Oh, and then if we were diehard and we wanted a rail yard for some commuter stuff, that we could put... Oh gosh, this is gonna look terrible. No, I'm not gonna do that. What are you doing? Get out of here. No, it's, I mean, no. No, no, no. Don't do it. Don't do it. I'm not gonna do it. I'm getting too carried away. Oh gosh. Tunnel! Yes! Oh my gosh, you guys are so clever. Very good idea. What if we made a tunnel? Oh, interesting. I like having you guys around, you're all very smart. Okay, let's go like this. And then... Tunnel at 12. Cool. Oh yeah, that's... Oh, that's gorgeous. Okay, where do we come out though? I guess up here, right? Now we are cooking! Okay, that's so much better. It makes the height here a little peculiar, so that's maybe not the best... Maybe not the best area to come from. Maybe at the connection point, actually. That's probably a better spot right there. I am drinking coffee there, as a matter of fact. Yes, I'm a coffee fanatic. It's so funny, like, when I was a kid, I remember, like, you know, I had a few sips of coffee here and there, and I was like, bleh, people drink this? Now I'm like, coffee, 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 coffee! Oh my goodness. Too funny. Okay, so that's connected. That works for me. That's kind of fun little bypass. The only thing about this, though, is that no one is going to unfortunately use it. We could, for sheer fun's sake, make this the way it connects, and then have a line of like static trains in the center. Oh my, what have you done here? Like, have our rail yard, like, you know, here or whatever, right? Oh, yes. Maybe, I mean, I don't know. I don't want to get too carried away with trains. As much as I love them, I don't want to be like a train, you know? A train overload. Okay, there's definitely a way to make these all talk with one another. I'm sure of it. Okay, so that can go like this. You can come in at two angles. Just for, like, fun? Right? I don't know. Okay, so that's going to be tricky because of the slope. But, I mean, even we can probably fit, like, one static train there. So I think that's kind of what I'm after right there, right? I prefer Tim Hortons to Starbucks. I will definitely say that Starbucks makes a better product. It's just at the end of the week when I've had 10 or 20 coffees, I would like to have an extra $10 or $20 in my pocket. That's all. Because really, I mean, you just drink coffee. It does its job. Tim Hortons, it doesn't taste bad, you know? I know Starbucks is bad. It also, it's a personal taste, right? Like, you don't really... Maybe, like, the boldness of Starbucks, right? Who knows? Okay, so what do I have in terms of props, even, for commuter trains? I downloaded some more. Not really a lot, right? There's this one here we can use as kind of, like, a fake little just starter. Otherwise, there's really none. It's all just cargo stuff. So we can put some locomotives here. That's fine. Maybe one or two just kind of just generic things. Okay, well, that's not so bad. So we'll delete some, say, that stretch of rail first. Put on our... Actually, I don't know if we need the no-collision when we're doing this part here. Actually, I don't mind the McCafe coffee as well, now that you mention it. I think McDonald's has really stepped up their game. And their stock price reflects that, so if you're an investor, you know? Actually, because I'm going to get nice and close here. So what I'm doing is I don't have the No Anarchy mod running. So I'm doing kind of like a little bit of a backup kind of trick to doing rail yards. So what you do is you put your props in first, and then you lay the rail afterwards using one of the Road Anarchy kind of mods. And then that way it kind of achieves what you're after, which is still kind of cool. I just have more props the other way. Like, I don't really have that much, you know, for this stuff, unfortunately. But we still have just enough to have some fun. And I unfortunately can't put them next to each other, just because of the way these work. So it's one side of the tracks only, but that's really not the end of the world. And so even though these aren't really commuter assets, and you can't really go up a hill with them, you can kind of see this is already starting to, you know. So I'm actually going to take just this out. Let's leave those three right there. And then now, when we do our rail, and we turn off our collision right here, and go straight over that. Ta-da! Beautiful. And you just get rid of all these trees, and these are just a result of the anarchy right there, but it is worth it. And then we get rid of the, you know? And then bada-bing, bada-boom, look at that! We've got ourselves the makings of a little bit of, you know, the old-fashioned trail, or train yard kind of thing here. Love it. Oh, what do we have here? Oh, Sigeria? Oh, Lithuania! Oh, cool! Oh, I wish I spoke some Lithuanian. I totally don't. No, I can't even make a joke. I used to date a Lithuanian girl. I didn't really pick up on too much of it, though. Yeah, see, these props here, I have a few of those already downloaded JBS, but they're part of the, whatchamacallits? Oh, gosh. Where are they? They're over here with the More Beautification mod, right? Not, More Beautification, is that the one? I think it's the one. Where are they? Parks, maybe? See, I have, I think I even have all those specific ones. Yeah, see, I have them all right here, right? Look at them all. So many of them. It's just these, you can see, I can't place, right? And, well, actually, I mean, let's test. Maybe stuff has changed since I last tried this, right? So let's do essentially the same thing over here. So let's put one down as a test. No need to go crazy here. And then returning that onto that. And holy sweet mother of... Oh my gosh. Well, this has changed my entire life. Wow, I don't know what to think anymore. I'm really happy we did that. Holy, you could not do this in the old days. And in the old days, I mean like a few months ago. Guys, our life has forever changed. That's so great. Great. Well, I mean, that just totally changes everything. Okay, well, let's put in some different trains now. Ooh, have fun. Okay, well, now that we know this is possible, we have so many more options. Wow. Well, thanks. I'm glad you guys kind of encouraged me to do this. This is great. Southeast Asia. Oh, that's right. Yeah, I remember you're Indonesia, right? Oh, JBS is buffering again. Yeah, I'm still at only 0.17, so 0.17% frames drop. So I don't necessarily think it's on my end. Okay, so I got those. Yes, these are the commuter ones. You just linked me, actually. So we'll have it facing. Oh gosh, this is such a great revelation here. We'll have that facing our station. And I guess theoretically you would just go in and then, you know, switch around at the station, right? That would be your transfer point. Okay, so let's do two of these. Are those close enough together? I think so. And this doesn't have to be like, you know, an exact science, right? Oh, Malaysia, that's where you are. Well, the missing aircraft are, right? I shouldn't joke about that. Actually, another airplane went down. Mr. Arrow is missing. Okay, so this is what I'm looking for. Some double-decker. Yeah. And we're just going to be cautious of that hill, because we can't go too far back into it, unfortunately. Ah, darn it. We can only get two in, it looks like. Oh, you know what? These ones here have a random chance of color. I'm going to delete that first locomotive, and I'm just going to do that, just because the colors kind of match. And now this means we can get trains running alongside one another too. That's good to know. Oh, there, Itchy King, what's going on? Happy Thursday to you. Hope things are good on your end. Okay, so this is a different style of commuter train prop. Yes, let's put some of those right here. Oh, we can even have an overlap slightly. Well, that's really convenient. Just so we know the angle, right? Oh, well, this is great, guys. This just made my day in a weird way. And the day is still early, too, right? Ah, the hill is kind of, you know, being not our friend again. Okay, well, three is more than enough, I think. And now that we know we have access to this, we can do many more elsewhere. So, turn off our collision. Let's go right up the block. I don't even know where these trees came from. There weren't even any trees underneath here before. Kind of interesting. Cool, there we go. Only 169 frames lost? Yeah, that's not so bad, right? I've only had 137 drops, so it's kind of, you know, we're in the same ballpark, right? Oh, darn it. You can kind of see I went too close on this side with one of them, right? Darn it. Is it worth doing that part again? I think so. Maybe we'll just do one side of the tracks, just for simplicity. And then we'll put the locomotive with that. And we'll do longer train stuff in the middle one. Okay, so let's delete. Do I want to delete that part? I should be able to reconnect that with any issues. Knock on wood. Okay, so we'll expand this right here. Yeah, I saw that mod too. I was just actually making jokes when this stream started. I finally, because everyone always asks me in the comments here too, they're like, how do you have so many props and assets and, you know, everything mods without your computer exploding? And I'm like, I don't know. But I finally this morning hit the you know, the straw that broke the camel's back. And so I have now I don't have as many, but I had 1400 and I think it was 1467 or 1487 mods slash assets total slash props. And so my poor computer, I couldn't run it. Like, the game would just crash every time I got into the lobby. And so I was like, well, shoot, there we go. So I had to remove like 50 or 60 just to get things back up and running, but there we go. That's kind of what we're after, right? Locomotive with some extra trains behind it, and I don't like the fact that we're on a slope, but again, not the end of the world there. KPD87, what's going on? Hope you're well today. Alright, so just these middle two areas are pretty much suitable for what we're after, right? And we can do some really, 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 really long ones. Because no one else is coming down here, right? So we don't have to worry about trains driving through. Oh, you know what'd be really cool? And I haven't done this in a long time. I do this for tests in like my own little personal cities. Is you put static trains on one side where you know traffic won't go, and that way you have like active trains moving through like a static train yard type thing, and that looks just like El Supremo Gangster. You know what I mean? If that makes any sense. Oh gosh. Yeah, the I think I'm gonna download it, but I have to remove a few other things first. Because I launched the game, you know, like right after I finally was able to launch it, and then, you know, like on the side there's that little menu just on the right that has like, you know, custom, like, you know, or the top downloaded mods of the day or of the week. And I instantly clicked on another one. I was like, oh, here's one. Maybe we can handle just one more, right? And then instantly my game crashed, and I was like, all right, fine. Fine. Simply press start. What's going on? A fellow streamer. You guys should follow her. She makes YouTube content, and she also streams on Twitch. I don't know if you guys have heard of Twitch or not. Oh, my. Okay, so I want to build lots of tanker cars, lots of coal, lots of, like, just generic freight kind of stuff, right? So let's start a little bit further down, and we'll do this in little segments, and... Oh gosh, I hope I don't regret deleting that part of the train there. Okay, well, it looks like I may have to do this in, like, these kind of segments. Just because, like, the snap points are going to be, unfortunately, uncooperative, which is not the end of the world. Okay. So, I need... Actually, I really like the look of this locomotive. These ones, especially in my mind... Actually, we'll do the locomotive at the end. Like, these really, really long trains usually have, like, two or three locomotives. So we'll do something really cool. Okay, I got so many different types of, like, almost the same kind of car, it looks like. So we'll do some tankers. Get them nice and straight. And just to avoid them overlapping, we'll just do, like, one side of the rails at a time or whatever. Let's get rid of these trees. Cool. That one may have been a bit crooked. Oh, you know we could use... Oh my gosh, guys. Oh my gosh. It just came to me. Okay, we're gonna try this. We're trying something. We're doing it. Alright, where is it? Draw line. How do we find what we're looking for? Holy smokes. Okay, snowman, ice decals. Oh, wow. Oh gosh, okay, so theoretically through this list is all the props we have downloaded, so all the trains, everything should be in here. So we should be able to do a, oh, I have, I have that one installed, actually, the one for the, asset icons. Not all of them are, unfortunately updated, though. Anyway, so what I was saying is the trains, they should be, in here, and then we should be able to do an actual line of them. And I haven't done this before, because I only just found out, like, you know, 10 minutes ago, 20 minutes ago, that you can even do this. Oh my gosh, so many props. This is why my game doesn't really, you know, run sometimes very well, right? Let's grab some coffee. We're in this for the long haul. It actually seems like they're going, in order of where they would be in the list or whatever. Which I guess makes sense, instead of just being random. Oh my gosh, guys. And then when I go through that little draggy thing on the side, it doesn't really seem to make a difference, right? Okay, so we should be coming up on our... Okay. Oh, so there's that. There's our train, right? Well, where are the other ones? Okay, maybe I take back what I said about them being in order, because this actually seems to be a little bit all over the place here. So I guess in terms of time, this is maybe not the most effective use. I mean, we probably could have just, you know, had three or four attempts at trial and error to try and, you know, get ourselves a straight line for trains. But I mean, really, this is finally kind of what we're after. But no, oh, and there's angles. Oh, wow! This is the coolest thing ever. no way! No way! Are you kidding me? This is so cool. Okay, let's try this again. okay, how do we figure this out? So we want to be 90 degrees. And then we need spacing of, say, 5 units. Let's try that. Oh, wow, this is so cool. Okay, 5 maybe? Nope, definitely not 7. Oh, long. Oh, it's really long. 10 unit spacing. We did it. Oh, gosh. Oh wow, this is so cool. They're really, really close together though. Ha ha ha, that's so neat. I don't think I would do this, like the amount of time it takes, right, to kind of figure this out, you know? That's pretty cool. Oh, is this another, what is this here? Oh, that's a cool train. The Amtrak Express here? I like that. You should run this on a laptop? Holy smokes. You're brave. I mean, laptops, they're pretty strong these days. I just feel like they overheat, like, really, really quickly. Like, these days, it's almost a must to have, like, one of those kind of cooling pads underneath it, right? Okay. I mean, it's not bad. It's just for the amount of time that took, right, to just get that little bit of train. Like, I don't think it's worth it. And they're too close together. But proof of concept is there, right? Okay, so we'll go back to doing it the old-fashioned way, which is fine. We are in no rush here. It's much easier just to find things like this anyway. Okay, let's move to some of these styles. Oh, we can get just close enough. Oh, it's beautiful. Beautiful. Okay. Just cautious of the slope. You can already see it starting to affect us. So that might just be the limit right there, which is fine. Fun and dandy. Alright. Okay, so that's that connected. That works for me. And we'll just now continue this just down, you know? Keep on going with it. I'm looking for some, like, boxcars, or these shell ones are pretty cool. Actually, let's use these. Oh, wait, no, we're not looking. We're looking for, the other ones. We already used these. Let's use the fun ones. Yeah, like these things here, right? They're pretty iconic. You would see this, I think, in a big line of trains. Yeah, see, for the amount of time that prop thing kind of saves us. But it is very, very, very cool for doing fences or like hedgerows or something like that. That I can totally see in it being worth every second we put into it. Then it's all straight, right? This is fine. Now that looks like it's slightly crooked. Yeah, so we kind of lost a bit of our shape there. That's fine. Try this again. Oh, and if possible, actually, let's get back a bit closer so it lines up. It looks like it's part of the same train. Oh, and it would be really neat if we can get this going underneath the bridge as well. Hopefully. Oh, come on, where is it? There we go. There's no LRC add-on? Oh gosh, what are we doing now? Totally in a different direction here. Oh, seem to be out of music. Let's move over to our next... Oh no, we're not over music. It's still another... Yeah, I think we'll change songs anyhow. Whoa, hello loud. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna delete these. Try one more time. I think it could be one of those third time's a charm kind of things. There we go. Now I wonder if it's the case maybe that the train tracks themselves aren't lining up straight, but they should. It's just like a straight line, I thought, in between these two directions, but sometimes the game, you know, has a mind of its own, right? I think that's fine or close enough, and we'll just kind of see what it looks like once we put the rails in, but again, this kind of stuff, I mean, it doesn't have to be a perfect, you know? It doesn't have to be exactly bang on. Just as good as we can get it is pretty good. No, did we delete? We did! No, by accident. I didn't realize these fall under the same... Oh, darn it. Darn it, darn it, darn it. Well, they are a little bit off anyhow. Okay. Interesting. Well, this is not proving to be as easy as I thought it would be, just like everything else that I try to do in this game sometimes. Oh gosh. Alright, let's try again. Okay, no zoning. That connects. The fact they are a little bit crooked, I don't want it to bother me, especially, you know, how many times we're doing this, so no problems. Still what we're after, though. And then we'll do something similar on this side, but maybe, you know, or when I say this side, I mean on this side of the bridge, but the opposite side of the tracks, just so things are mixed up slightly. Not mixed up, just changed up. Okay, so more of these. Excellent. Oh, the 1080? Yeah, it's so expensive, though. Like, I really want a 1080, guys. I'm really debating whether or not to spring for the 1080 or just get a... I don't even know. Like, it has to be a minimum 980, because I'm looking to do some VR support. And I only have a 960 now, and that's not enough for VR. And if I'm going to get a 970, like, I might as well spend the extra and get a 980. But I saw the US price point of the 1080, and I got really excited because I was like, oh, that should convert pretty well. Not the case at all. It's like over $1,000 for Canada, which is like so frustrating. Oh well. What can you do? Take care, Shaggy Dog. I'll see you in the next one. So we'll be streaming again on Sunday, guys. Just in case you a little bit late, you know, arriving today or this and that. And I'm probably going to stream for at least another hour. I was only going to do about 2 hours or so today. I've got it's a workshop at the YouTube studio, of all places. So that should be kind of fun. And these look a little bit crooked. It's actually a workshop that allows me to unlock, it's called like unlock the space, so I can start using the YouTube studio that it built in Toronto. And so they have a VR thing set up there, so I'm going to try and use that, hopefully. Which should be kind of cool. So I'm there today, which will be fun, and I'm there next week as well. What are these Founder Editions? LRC train? Here, I'll keep this in the background. I usually have like a really good list of links that you guys send me as the stream goes on. Slightly crooked again. I wonder what's causing that. I wonder who's the blame, you know? It's not really by much, though, is it? Just slightly. Well, let's draw the train, or the tracks in, and see if that actually is that bad. I wonder where all these trees keep coming from. Because from what I can tell, we delete them all. Oh, that's fine. Things always seem so much worse in my head. Alright, now no one should be coming down this way, so we're safe to do a little bit more of this. We're not exactly making these too beefed up. No! Oh, I hate when that happens. Okay, let's try this again. Okay, luckily it's an easy fix. There we go, that's not so bad. Okay. Reference board. Oh, NVIDIA wants to keep... Yeah, it's. I mean, NVIDIA, they're pretty much dominating the market, though. It's like, these days, like... I mean, I won't, like... I don't know. Like, ATI, they still make good cards. It used to be all about ATI, but it's just... I don't know. Anyone these days, whenever they talk about video cards, it's the first thing out of their mouth is, like, NVIDIA this or NVIDIA that, it seems. It's not a bad thing. It's just, like, I think they're kind of, you know... They could kind of lower the price maybe a little bit, but... They're taking advantage of the fact that people associate them with a better card, perhaps. This is just me speculating, though. Okay. Either way, I think it's worth spending a little bit more on a video card, especially because you're going to have it for, like, so long, and it's such a key component. Like, really, with all parts of your computer, like, I don't recommend cheaping out. Like, you know, even if you have to wait an extra, you know, 2-3 paychecks or whatever, just buy better parts. Like, whatever your budget is, you know, add, like, 200 more type of thing. Because, I mean, you should have a computer for, you know, 3, 4, 5 years. So, I mean, it's worth spending a little bit more on, I think. Call me crazy, though. Alright, we don't really have too many locomotives in play in our little freight yard just yet. So maybe we can use that one that I was taking a fancy to earlier. Even if it's just one. And if we start curving it, it might maybe work with that little bit of a slope approach. I think so. Maybe just enough. Okay. It looks like we lost one over on that side, but I don't know if that's going to really... Oh, gosh. Okay. Instead, I think we're actually going to add to the line over here. Oh, we just lost the ones on this side? Oh, boy. Boy, oh, boy. This game is quite the sense of humor sometimes, it seems. It's not that they're lost, they're just hiding underneath the tracks. It's one of those, like, I wouldn't say it's a clipping issue, but... Game doesn't know who needs to be on top type thing. See, there's everybody, right? Okay, so trains. Hopefully, we'll cross our fingers this works. Bada bing. And... troublemaker, huh? Oh my gosh, there's just no... Oh, there's no perfect crime, is there? Alright, so in stages, we will do this. Oh my goodness, this is too funny. So, first side I'm gonna do is this side. And that'll connect here. Straighten that back out. Next, we do that side. And then this curves in as well. There we go. And then now we get rid of all these extra trees. We know to not get too close to the trains as we do so, because the trains are kind of treated as the same type of asset, it would seem. Well, that took forever, but finally we got something done. That's kind of what I was after, I think. It was 750 Ti. Oh, that's old school. In my other computer, just sitting, like, you know, right behind me or whatever, I have a 760 in there. That was like my old champion. I love that card. Great card. Like, going from a 760 to a 960, holy smokes, that was great. I mean, I'm willing to wait it out, too, just a few more weeks to kind of see prices go down, but it's just good to see new cards coming out, too, just in general. Alright, so more issues, eh? Yeah, this game, it has a sense of humor. Can't say it doesn't. So we'll do a few more lines of some train cars here. And then I think we're going to start shifting our attention to growing the city and getting some, you know, population numbers up and that kind of stuff. Okay. And we can do, like, coal cars. Oops, probably should have opened that up before we started our little look through here. Now I have a few. Or we can do steel. Those are always good too, actually. Bulkheads and that kind of just construction things. Oh, it would make sense to have some empty ones. Oh, cool. Ah, there's a hill. I see. Sneaky, sneaky. Alright, with that in mind, maybe we'll just put like two or three of these in. Yeah, because really the terrain's going to be... Oh yeah, it's very uncooperative, right? Okay, so I think we're going to just put the tracks in. Or we can go, I guess, back this way. I risk not being able to recreate that intersection, though. So I'm kind of playing with fire here a little bit, but... Let's risk getting burned here, guys. Let's do it! Alright. Now, maybe one or two of these can be full. Just add some variety. Like, here's one, right? And I guess in real life, you would use these for, like, timber or steel or just, like, you know, big, oversized construction materials, like piping, for, like, infrastructure, like that kind of stuff. Well, that's kind of cool. Adds a little bit of, you know, realism and fun to our city, I think. And I'm curious to see if maybe we can continue to go up, because I don't think the hill's actually as big of an issue as I thought it was going to be. Yes, let's continue up a little bit here. Oh, I remember the old days when, like, single-core processors were around. I remember the first computer I built, actually. Like, it blows my mind that we're, like, you know, quad-core and above now. Like the i7, it is just an incredible powerhouse of a processor. So for those of you that are considering doing a computer upgrade, and you're, like, debating between, like, an i5 and an i7 or something, go for the i7. Again, like, you know, like, wait that extra paycheck if you have to. Like with a car or something, you know, it's a big purchase. You should to do a lot of research, invest properly. Not saying you guys aren't, right? But spend that extra. So my biggest regret is not spending more on some of my key components, because I had to do a few computer upgrades just throughout the year, just to play a little bit of catch up. And one of them happens to be the video card. So lesson learned, though. There, that's more fun. Okay, now cross your fingers we don't run into the same kind of trouble as we did down there connecting everything. Okay, so that goes to there. That seems to be okay. And we're just going from here up to here on that side. Oh no, you can kind of see we're a little bit off the rail. Oh no! Well, since that's the case, I'm just going to remove the ones that are... Oh no, it's those ones too! Okay, well with that in mind, I'm going to reverse this. I'm going to do that part again. So we'll start angling the trains a little bit, just going in the opposite direction there. Oh, water cooling. Oh, that's something that, like, the idea of it, it sounds so promising and awesome, but I am horrified in real life to do it. And I have one friend out of, like, my whole troop that has successfully pulled it off. And it's an older computer, but it's still a nice one, but I don't know. Like, you have no one to blame but yourself type thing, so... And then computers, too, it's like, you know, if you're mobile, if you're going to LAN parties a lot, it just makes me very nervous to think that it's getting moved and this and that. I've always actually wanted to build a shuttle. Like, this, like my current PC I made as tiny as possible, just so it's a lot more portable, because my last one was, like, you know, like a server-size case, just so I can get all the extra lights and all this other fun stuff in there. I'm gonna use some more of these hoppers. These are kind of good. Maybe a different color one though. There, use these guys here. But I was saying in the last stream, and maybe even some of the recordings, it's really nice to see that there's a lot of variety and options out there for, you know, building computers. And at the pace at which stuff is now upgrading and you know, coming out, you're seeing a lot of much higher quality secondhand parts in the market. So it's opening PC gaming up to a really wider audience, which I think is totally great. Okay, now who did we lose over here? There we go, just that part again. Because consoles, you know, I don't want to start the great debate, right? Because consoles, they serve their purpose. They're very fun. It's just they're becoming expensive. And it's that the lines are becoming skewed. It's like, it shouldn't be a console versus PC war. Like, in my mind, they're different things. They're trying to compare, you know, a car to a motorcycle, right? Like, they both drive, they're just for different, you know? They serve different purposes. But consoles are becoming expensive, and, like, you know, with the whole PS, like, 4.5 or whatever you want to call it coming out, right? Having a $500 or $600 console upgrade every year doesn't necessarily sound all that exciting anymore, so... That also is opening the door to PC gaming for a lot of new people. Because if you're on a budget, you know, $500, $600, $700, you can still get a really decent, you know, gaming computer. Some of the parts might be secondhand, maybe you can talk your friends into doing an upgrade, you can go Splitsville, you buy their old parts, you know, that kind of stuff. There we go, we're starting to come together here. This is cool, right? Not the biggest train yard, but we got something in here. Something to show for our hardware. I like it. All right, well, let's press play, and let's try and tackle some of this demand. Actually, it's growing pretty quickly here. All right, I should put on 3-speed for a second, and I'm just gonna stare at traffic just overall, because there might be some areas that need some attention. Mainly, what in the heck is this crazy old thing that we built here? It's a very interesting bypass. We'll just put it that way. My thoughts, though, for doing this was to have a way for people to get to this part of the highway here without having to cross in front of too much traffic. So the bypass essentially does its job. This traffic light stops people from getting all, you know, crazy chaotic down here. We can always try, I think I have to do some off-camera time with this, but we can try doing traffic president stuff to make, like, you know, yielding and, like, you know, priority turning, that kind of stuff. And that's silly how that guy just went that way, right? But I can't really turn that off because then no one goes that way. So I don't know. Something might have to give over there eventually, but... I like this interchange. This is kind of fun. Okay. Let us build. Ooh, what is happening over here? Oh, right, I remember this whole... yeah, that was very good. This is the bypass we put in. It's just starting to fill up. I wonder... See, these are the areas where you don't have to do too much, but just even going from, say, two lanes to four lanes, you just double the size for, you know, people to queue type thing. So maybe three lanes is a bit more realistic. And that way, instead of all of them parking their butts over on the little, I want to say, like, you know, collector lane, they're on in here. So that looks like it's just enough to kind of fix that problem. Okay, next to our school, I want to put some trees actually right here. Just while I see this before I forget. And then we should tack on some more high-density residential areas. So I want to be a little bit aggressive with the population now. I think we should have some more people living here, all things considering. Because our budget, it should be a lot higher. I know we have like almost 5 million credits here, but... If we're going to start doing things like subway and... Or the metro, whatever you guys want to call it. Like, and like add some bus lines, some more tram lines. Like all that, it's going to cost a lot of money, so... We gotta get ourselves ready. We may also need to do a second university campus. Oh, and I was hoping to put it in like a sports stadium too. Oh, we got so much I want to do here. Oh my goodness. Well, good afternoon. Who is this, Mr. Boink? Or Mr. Bonk? Oh, Bonkif? Oh gosh. So yeah, some of you guys would, I know like it's random with the font color, but I'm on night mode, and so whenever it's navy blue fonts on the gray or dark black, it, like, it's so hard to read. I have, at this intersection, I do have a no left hand. Oh gosh, where was it? It was this one. Sorry, I have the no left hand hand. Gosh, thing. I had this set up before, but no one was respecting it. So we can turn it off to make them both turn right. But then people. I mean, it should still. Yeah, we'll try that. It wasn't working well for me last time, so I don't know why. But maybe we'll just kind of leave it be. Okay. Back to one speed. No need to kind of blow through this too quickly. And then I think for a high density neighborhood expansion, we can maybe sneak a few buildings here. Probably not the best spot. Where we realistically could start doing like a suburb kind of in this hill. Take advantage of this little pond here. And I still maybe want to make a marina over here and then add to our little beach kind of area. Yeah, so for those of you that missed the first part of the last stream, this is what we kind of made, this little fun beach thing, but we didn't quite finish it. So we put in some some benches and some lighting, but it didn't really quite finish, right? So I think we need some, boat access, you know, harbor stuff. And then make it a little roller coaster and theme park kind of thing over here, too. Kind of cute, kind of fun. I like this. Some sea walls, too. Very nice. The right lane's still able to turn left there. Oh, did I miss that one? Oh yeah, good eye indeed. Perfect. So we'll just, yeah, we'll come back to that. I mean, I don't know. This kind of stuff is ongoing, right? Now, as far as expansion goes, we can sneak a little bit in here. And high density is the best bang for the buck right now. And we're so close to unlocking essentially all of this, right? All we need to do is get to 70,000, and then that at that point we can just take a very, very leisurely approach at just our zoning, which is fine by me. Yeah, I was thinking of doing the same thing too to kind of soften that. It's a work in progress, so we'll see how the time goes. But I want to just get our population up. But I think we could possibly make a change there. Now, is it crazy talk to have a tram come down, do a little circle in here, and then leave? Or would that be better served as from a bus, do you think? Oh gosh, these are such hard questions. Well, let's do a cute little tram line through here, because why not? That sounds actually really pleasant. Oh, we can even sneak one underneath? Oh, that is so nice. Sometimes when this kind of stuff happens, I don't know why, I just think it's great. Look at that, perfect! So I want to have a gentle downslope right here, as long as we can make this. Make that just an intersection. Oh, this will be really nice. And that'll just be a nice, gentle kind of curve. Just kind of over to here type thing. Oh yes, this is so lovely. And then we'll put some inner neighborhood roads here. I think that'll be a nice combination as well. And so I think we're at about, I want to say the halfway point with the stream, guys. We've been going for about an hour and 20 minutes or so. I'm probably going to stream for just over 2 hours today. But we'll be streaming again this coming Sunday. And I haven't necessarily picked out a time. It's holiday long weekend here in Canada, so I may have some obligations to go see my family. We'll kind of see how time unfolds, but I'm thinking just early afternoon. But I'll keep you guys posted. So if you guys want to follow along on the old Twitters... Oh, you're funny, eh? Well, you can still pause it. You just, when you return, it's not where you left off type thing. But I will be uploading this to the YouTube page afterwards, so in case you guys did miss part of it or just came a little bit late type thing, the options will be there for you to view this again. Now, there's a lot of dead space here. Maybe we can sneak another road, even if it's a small one, like one of these kind of guys. Oh, and so for those of you just tuning in now, holy smokes, I was just scared this morning. So I couldn't get the game to work. I finally hit, I keep calling it like the straw that broke the camel's back. But my tally was like 1480 or so mods slash assets total. And I literally could not run the game. Like this morning when I tried, I woke up early to try to do some more tutorials, but it just, I couldn't get the game to go. Oh, that was too funny. So I had to scale back. So some of you have been sending me some over the last few days, and I had to unsubscribe to quite a few of them, so I apologize for that. It's just, I just couldn't get the game to go, so I took out like 40 or 50. So that was good at least, but oh my goodness. Alright, so this will be mostly high density. We're going to surround it with a little bit of low density here too. Actually, I think where the train's going to be, just for the sake of the noise, I'm going to make these into some commercial spots. And it would be kind of nice to have some like little summer home slash cottagey kind of houses just around the water's edge right here. And I think it would look really cute just having a tram just, you know, sneak on through here. Okay, so let's do that. Oh, and I had some actually comments come in from the YouTube section that we should be doing a little bit of a focus on some nightlife. And we really haven't picked out a zone where the nightlife area is going to be per se, but that's something we should totally keep an eye on. Now I think what we're going to do for this tram line is maybe make a loop in here, go over here, make a loop over here. That way it just kind of serves as kind of like a transfer line. So we'll almost go, say like this, just to make it a little bit long and strange, so it gets a bit more people using it. And then we're going to go up like this. And then we'll go in over here. And I guess we're just going the one way. Not that we really have to worry about going two directions because of how small this area is. But like anything else in the city, none of this is set in stone, so everything can be changed. Now, where are we going to go with this? Are we going to go right back to here, or are we going to try and... I think we should take advantage of this area and just kind of go back like this. Just encourage some more use of this line in general. But then we can go this way. And complete like that. A little bit unique. I want that so I can change the color. And only in this view. Perfect, there we go. We'll change this to red, just like we've been doing with the rest of the lines. Perfect. Alex Gamer, what's going on? Thanks for stopping by. How are you doing today? I unfortunately don't speak Russian. But, yeah, I don't even know any Russian. I was gonna say good day, but I don't even know how to say that. I know it's like Dobro is Serbian, and I know in Russia, or Russian I should say, like Dobro, like good sounds similar to that, so it's something like that, you know? Oh, we should totally have some nightlife at the uni. Oh, that's a good idea. I think we actually talked about that, but we totally forgot to do it though. Why don't we change, since this is already zones, well, I don't want themes. I want... what am I looking here? Specialization, that's right. We can just make this right away nightlife, right? That'll just convert these buildings over. Okay, that's cool. That's a good starting point already. But we should pick like, another spot. Maybe not this very second. Let's kind of get some more... Let's get our population up. And then once we do a little bit more work on the population, we'll sneak a peek at services, because there are a few icons kind of popping up here. Like, this one needs an easy fix, but... Like, these new areas we're making, I'm sure, are going to need, like, schools or that kind of stuff. Dos Vendania? Yes, I don't know how to even pronounce that. How are we doing for water otherwise, though? Yeah, sewage, we're getting close. Gosh, look at this demand, though, right? Look how fast this area just filled up. And look how awesome that is with the trams, right? This is so pretty. I love it. Very nice. So let's sneak a school in here, because I know that'll be the best bang for the buck, I think. Oh, that'd be perfect to get one in here. Oh, it does fit. Oh, beautiful. Cool. Cool. I like it. Now, going back over to here, did we get this working? Is this connected, and do we see trains coming? I haven't really been sneaking a peek at this yet. Otherwise, how is this little junction and stuff doing as well? It's always, you know, it's a challenge, right? Making your industrial areas work well. So I'm going to add a traffic light just right here. Wherever there's a lot of traffic crossing in front of other vehicles, I'm just going to add traffic lights, because as the city grows, it just becomes way too chaotic. Oh, I'm not going to, I know what that means. I'm not going to pronounce that, or I'm not going to say that out loud. I think most people, the first thing they learn when they learn a new language is the bad words. What, Hardcore Henry? I haven't even heard of that. Is it like a family-friendly movie? I'm guessing by the title. Oh, goodness. So we should hopefully see some commuter trains coming in through here. And that way people coming from other parts of the city or from outside. Actually, what are we connected to in terms of passenger trains right here? This is an internal train line, so we have one right here. So hypothetically, anyone living in this area could hop on a train, come down here to work. As we expand on that network, that'll become more popular, but... My long-term plan with the city in general is just to get a lot of people using public transit. Like, the more people we can keep off the roads, the better. That's kind of our plan here. I think that's fine like that. And I'm actually going to build a little office kind of zone over here in our industrial area. Just to kind of meet a little bit of this demand. How are we going to do this? Let's see, like here, just another traffic light. And you can see the traffic lights themselves are not really impeding traffic right now. They're just there as kind of a... You know, to act like almost like a policeman, right? Just to make sure that everyone's kind of obeying the lane laws and all that stuff properly. Okay, now I'm going to make a little off kind of shoot access like this, but I'm going to do it connecting only to the side roads, not to the highway thing itself. And then maybe we can just sneak one more through here. And that's just a pretty good use of the space. We can get some office, you know, type stuff in here. I think we just need maybe like a parking lot or two. Tricky though, because of the slope. Oh my, that's actually very sloped. Holy smokes. Okay, so maybe no parking lots here, but let's put in some office style assets. Actually, mix it up. Let's do kind of a mix of office and industry. And then maybe we can get some commercial? I don't know. I'm kind of feeling the mix here suddenly. Oh, you're from Finland. Oh, cool. Yeah, Finland's where the it's where the game comes from. Actually, I've talked to some of the game developers. Same with the community manager, like that kind of stuff. They're actually very friendly because they reach out to some of the YouTubers, which is cool. So I sometimes get like, you know, when the game gets an update, I might get that a few days early, which is always fun. I like bringing you guys that kind of content. Always makes my day too when I get to chat with them. I always say, I'm like, guys, I've said it 100 times, your game is great. Have I told you that yet? And they're like, yes. I'm like, it's so good. Oh man. I would love to go to Helsinki. Like, as far east as I've traveled is basically Great Britain. Like, that's it. I've been to most of the UK. Otherwise, I'm landlocked in North America, and I've been to, like, you know, parts of the Caribbean and stuff. But I need to do a lot more traveling. Okay, now what is happening over here? It looks like this area is just getting a lot of the truck traffic. They're kind of going from the harbor over to here to maybe deliver some goods. So I don't want to discourage that, because this is totally fine to have this kind of traffic in a you know, our industrial area. I'm just going to give them a little bit more area to work with. So why don't we go like that, and you know, we could even do, just for pure funsies. We already do too much funsie stuff lately. Let's do something funsies now, right? I'm just going to move this fire station, maybe just down the road over there. And then for pure funsies, let's use this style of road. Let's maybe move this. And I'm just going to change the speed limit on that. Just, I mean, this is literally for fun. So we'll treat this almost like an in-town expressway. But so that we get a fun kind of industrial look and feel to it, we're going to do extra wide roads. It's got that center median thing. And my logic for this is that, like, this would be a more suitable road for trucks, because you can take, like, wider turns, you know, that kind of stuff. Cool. Okay, these little upgrades I like. And then it just basically doubled the lanes too, so you won't really see as big of a backup. Oh, the interest city, you're absolutely right. It won't work until we create it. Oh, actually, I don't know. I don't know about that. Will it? I feel like it's... oh, gosh. One second, let's pause this. I feel like you're probably right, but I think I've seen intercity train lines go without creating a line, but I feel like that's not true. No, I feel like, no, you're absolutely right. What am I saying? I'm totally wrong here. What did I have for breakfast? Okay. That is that fixed. Did we mess up our zoning squares? We did. Easy fix them. And I might actually just remove that little building. Oh, okay, never mind. That's fine. We can put that back in. Okay, so that is that fixed. We'll need to bring some water over here. We're probably going to have to put in a new sewage treatment plant relatively soon. Should put the speed back up. I just want to get us that, you know, higher population. Which we're slowly working towards. I just don't know, you know? Sometimes it feels like we're going in circles here. And I'm also nervous, because we should be getting close to another death wave, to be honest. Let's look at our people graphs here. Yeah, it's not so bad. I remember when we were losing a lot of numbers, our seniors were at 25%, so a lot of them have died off. Which is always so morbid whenever I talk about this kind of stuff, right? So let's make ourselves an internal train line from here, because you guys are absolutely right. We will not have anyone coming. So from here. I think just going from here. It's the only way we can kind of connect to you so far, right? Which is fine. It just means we gotta work on this. Alright, now let's change the color of this. Let's just make it a black train line. Oh, yes! I have a lot of custom trains, so we're gonna see others than just, you know, the default ones. But yes, there we go! Cool! Oh, I remember when we did this too, right? So I'm probably gonna do this throughout other pockets of the city, where we just put some lighting through our train system. Oh, that's so cool! Oh gosh, oh guys, I love trains so much. I love the city at night. Holy smokes, it's so gorgeous. And I have that mod running that removes the pollution and the clouds and the fog and all that stuff. So it just looks so much cleaner. Oh gosh. I would totally live here. This is a fun place. Alright, population, let's do it. Okay, I think when we last looked at this area, we were staring at some of the services. Let's do the whole city while we're at it. Looks like we can use some more healthcare coverage right about here. Maybe even right down in this spot. See right there. That fills that in. And how is death care? Not so bad, actually. I think that's good enough to keep fire coverage. We talked about that a lot in the last stream. I think it's fairly decent. I'm going to put something over here, though, just for safety's sake. Oh, that does fit. Oh, cool. Oh, that's a nice building. I love this one. Oh, it's so pretty. Oh, very nice. And that was a Dutch train, yeah, that was. I've got some German trains, some like a whole bunch of just custom ones. I have a really cool Canadian freight train as well. Let's see if I can track one of those down. They're like the extra long. So, like this one, I think, is a German commuter train. This red one. I just like variety. And then for those of you, like, if that's like a train in your home city, when you see it, you're just like, you're like, whoa, that's so cool. I like that feeling too. So when I see one of the Canadian ones, I'll give a yell, but they're really long. They're cool. Because I don't know how it is in Europe, but like in Canada and probably in the States too, it's like the freight trains are so incredibly long that it is just insane. In a good way. Because that means you wouldn't, you know, you would have all that traffic on the road otherwise, which is not a good thing. Because trains are an incredibly efficient way to get goods around. I'm going to make this a shopping district simply because of how noisy it's going to be with all the trains and, you know, highway kind of pieces going through. But for there to be a little bit more purpose, I'm going to put in some offices as well. And then we'll get a little bit of height here, which will be kind of fun. And then the rest of these areas, I'd like to fill in with trees and rocks and just kind of a repeat of... Oh gosh, this area here, I want to do kind of an extension of like this kind of idea. I think that's kind of a fun way to make nature kind of meet your infrastructure. Yeah, like 100, definitely like mile long plus, definitely long ones. Okay, so where can we sneak some more high density in? It's interesting. We have a lot of space, but we don't have a lot of space at the same time, right? This area here is definitely prime. Now, are we going to keep this courthouse here? It's a really fun building. I don't see why we wouldn't want to keep it. So maybe we can do something like this around it. So build ourselves here a little neighborhood. And changes the slant a little bit here, that slope. That, I think, is a little bit too steep, especially with the fact that we're going to have the trams going through. So instead, we're going to go to here, and then we're going to go... Oh, I know what we're going to do. We're going to bring this one up. So let's go like that. Just go across like this. And then maybe we can sneak something like that, right? Just take advantage of those other intersections. Yes, I quite like this. And then these should probably connect here. And then I'd like to put some parking lots and some more government-style buildings. Oh, out in Colorado in the mountains there, yeah. You know what I really like? And it probably shouldn't be too hard if you guys do a Google search for it. You can find the trains that are going through the tunnels where they're like over top of themselves type thing. Like they're making the big kind of figure eight, almost like a figure eight thing. And then, you can kind of see like the train, the actual length of it. It's pretty wild. So we'll do that. I get so excited by train stuff. And it looks like because of the way the zoning squares are lined up, we have to use the wider roads here. Okay, so we'll put some offices in those spaces there. And then I'd like to use something else just, you know, right here, right? Maybe not this building per se. I think it's a little bit too tall, right? Oh, this is City Hall from Toronto. That's not going to fit, though. Oh, see, I knew I had another roller coaster. I knew it. Knew it. Remember before I was trying to find my other ones? I knew they were here. Gosh, of course we can't. Of course. Okay, well let's sidetrack for 2 seconds here. Otherwise, I will totally forget to use this. Turn up our intensity. A really handy mod to have is infinite soil. So yeah, this doesn't really... Nothing moves right there. That is the handiest thing. Because by default, you have to relocate the soil, which is a great challenge to add to the game. But if you're in a rush, kind of feeling like me when you're building your stuff, you don't want that, but good on them for adding a little more depth to the game in that sense. Alright, I will find a way to work that in a little bit better. It's just, I want to put that there so we don't forget. Okay, now where was that little office spot we were working on? Gosh, how did I just lose that? Oh, here we are. Oh, that wasn't the spot. I genuinely have lost it. Oh gosh. Where was it? Guys, help me out here. What part of the city were we just in here? Zoning. Oh gosh, I really am lost. Where was it? You guys have to help me out here. I'm not joking. I have my thinking cap on. Wasn't it just, I thought it was right around here, wasn't it? Oh gosh, this is so embarrassing. Oh, it's right here! Oh, I'm so, oh gosh. Terrible. Trains cross, I did say that. Yes, that's the one I'm talking about. That's it. Nice, killing my background internet by having all this stuff open, but that's perfect. Okay, so back over here. I almost need to like drop myself landmarks, right? Oh, this is a great building to use. This was suggested by the comments, actually, from my previous stream. Yeah, I would like to use this. I'm gonna maybe move it a little bit further back, though, just so it's not as close to the courthouse building. Oh, I think I'm just one square. I am. I was hoping to have, actually maybe a parking lot just kind of through here, right? And we'll do a pathway in between the two. And we'll just go like this. And then my idea behind that was to have a little bit of separation between the height so that, you know, the courthouse doesn't really get lost in tall buildings, basically. I know, yeah, KPD, don't judge. I'm lost totally in my own city here. I need, like, GPS. That's so fun. I literally totally forgot where we were. I'd be a bad cabbie, apparently. That looks kind of neat, though. Okay. That's fine for the moment. I'm still kind of keeping an eye on the sewage levels there, which are just barely. And maybe some trees next to this building with like a walking path. Something, say, like this. Oh, that's so, just so nice, right? Let's connect these. I don't know what it is. It's just so simple, but so delicious. Almost, you know? Gosh, right? I did use that term to describe. Oh, wow, that does kind of work as well. Okay. Hmm. Yeah, sure. Why not, right? Kind of an interesting mix. I like that. Yeah, the courthouse is kind of cool, right? Alright. It's kind of a neat building in itself. It reminds me of the main city hall from SimCity 2013. Let's drop in some of these trees here just to mix things up. And I think, yeah, there we go. I think we can find some snap points in between everything just to add some. Oh yes, that looks so cool! Remember guys, it's all about the little things. Bring up our sunshine. Oh, have you guys actually seen the movie Sunshine? Oh, I suddenly thought of that. It's an interesting movie. I want to watch that again, to be honest. It's been a while since I've seen that. Okay, so that is fine and dandy like that. That's actually, I really like that. And this area, I had in mind mostly high density stuff. So we'll just do some high density zoning in and around this little hill here. Which should look kind of cool once it's all filled in. And since we have such high demand, let's just drop those in right away. And I'm still looking to put some more parks or plazas in and around this area, just to kind of keep it a little bit more open kind of feeling still. Oh, you never heard of that movie? Yeah, it's an older movie. It's like, I want to say one of those like indie style movies, right? But it's It basically, it's like set in the future, and it's a space exploration team. They're being sent into space, sorry, obviously, to restart the sun. Like, the fusion reaction in the sun is stopped, and Earth is, like, kind of freezing to death type thing. So it's an interesting movie. It's kind of sci-fi and kind of fun. Definitely not Little Miss Sunshine. Oh, goodness, no, that's a very different movie. Oh, here, let me see, Sigeria, is that the one? That's the one, Sunshine, 2007. Yes, that's it. That's a cool movie. You guys should look at the trailer if you have a second. Okay, so let's put some plazas in and around here now. Spacing, my favorite game to play. Okay. So since we can't get perfect symmetry here with our spacing, we're gonna have to do our best to kind of make something work. Alright, so let's just make some hybrid areas here. And when I say hybrid, I mean we'll kind of work in some pathways of our own and just... There we go, that's better. Kind of make it a mix of just custom parks and actual parks. That way we get the land value bump and the area has a cool, kind of unique, custom kind of look to it as well. There we go. Well, this is becoming much more fun. So like that. And yeah, maybe zone some low density, some residential, some lucky people get to live over here, and then I want some commercial just over here as kind of like a little boundary, and then I'm thinking this can be more park space or just open courtyards or something, right? And that way the courthouse again is a little bit more front row and center. It really is a cool building. Look at that, very, very empowering, right? The true administration of justice is the first pillar of good government. Oh, okay, that's good. So there you go, you have a good, you know, no corruption, basically. That's good, that's what they're trying to say, right? Okay. Yeah, I recommend the movie. Go watch it. Become kind of a fun little Sunday flick to watch, you know? Or a Friday flick, I should say. I think it feels like a Saturday. Now, something we could do if we wanted to avoid having all of these traffic lights is maybe change this one into a one-way, and if it's the intake road like this, yeah, we lose the traffic light. So let's do that. And then we'll do some more... So we'll fill this spot in first. What do we have here? So many buildings. Oh my gosh, like so many buildings. Speaking of trains, do you guys hear the... Oh no, I had no idea. That must have been a long time ago. That'd be so horrifying as a passenger to get stuck in like a mountain, get snowed in. When was it? This would have been a few months ago, but there's a power outage downtown in Toronto, and some people got stuck in one of the subway tunnels. Like one of the trains got stuck in between the stations, right? Or actually quite a few did. That would not be a fun way to spend your afternoon, you know? Okay, and so all I'm basically looking for right now are some cool office-y... Wow, this is like a giant building. Maybe that'll be really nice here. Whoa, that is crazy empowering. Oh my gosh. Ooh, what are our thoughts on this? I don't know, that's the tallest building in town so far. I don't know, is that too much? Like, that is a really big building. I don't know, what do you guys think here? I don't say we'll vote on it, but let me see some thoughts, you know? It's cool, though. Otherwise, what do we have here? Scotia Plaza. This is a building out of Toronto. Some more tall skyscrapers. I mean, maybe we can fit a few just tall buildings in around here. Just kind of make this area a bit more... Ah, the texturing's a little bit of an issue with that, right? See, I don't know if I'm 100% on this building. But I like that building, but then it's like the texturing doesn't really work per se for me, right? That little Scotia Bank logo is so funny. This is an actual building in the city of Toronto, so this is really cool to see this right here. So anyways, it's kind of fun. Oh, you do like it, eh? Okay, well, okay. That's a good passionate answer. I like that. Or what else do we have? We have these buildings, too. Oh, gosh. Do we have any curved... Alright, where do we use this? Okay, let's put in those other big ones again. Seems you guys are a fan of these. Where was it? So that one was there. That we can do. And then... I'm not opposed to this. I just think it's a little bit off, you know, in terms of the textures. But it's just cool having some dominating buildings on the skyline. Just, I wish the textures, you know what I mean? Oh, gosh. Oh, okay, vote for the other direction now. You don't think it's in the right spot? Yeah, I don't know, right? I don't know. I do not know. See, when I'm close in, I don't mind them. It's just when I'm far away, it's like for screenshots and this and that, right? Like, I think that's gonna drive me crazy, like both of them, right? I don't know here, guys. I think we're heading in the right direction, I just don't think these are necessarily them. Maybe something that's kind of an in-betweener. Or something that's still kind of unique, you know? Oh, I love this part of the song. More Toronto assets. I just feel like all of them might maybe have that texture issue though. And is this one even done up for nighttime? It is done up for nighttime, but it's still not really that nice for textures. Oh, I don't know. Why is this so tricky? Oh, that's a cool. Yeah, the San Francisco. I know which building you're referring to. Alright, well, I originally had in mind here, like, plazas and that kind of stuff, so I don't know why I'm going for such tall buildings, but... It'd just be nice to have just one tall kind of... Oh, transport tower, it's another nice building, right? There, this one I think we can do. That one's not as insane. That I'm totally on board with. And I don't know what's up with my draw distance. Like, I have a mod, that works with, like, assets and stuff, so they still show up and render at afar. It might maybe have some kind of effect on the buildings too. That just looks a little strange, but this I think we'll keep. I like that. Okay, so in these open spots here, this looks like it's prime for some parks right now. Oh, and we had talked about wanting to do some flags too. So I'm gonna make like, I want to get like, I think the UN actually exists as a, CN Tower? Okay, we can put one of those in. One of those, the CN Tower, the only one in. Where is the CN Tower? That's a pretty good question. Oh, here you are. Oh my gosh, this thing is so big. Okay, so let's put that right there. And we have to put, like, Skydome next to it. I have it. There you are. Oh, of course it doesn't fit. Darn it. Okay, let's move this road. Is this really what we're doing here? Are we actually doing this? Okay. Put that in the center right there. Ha ha ha! That's so cool! Oh my goodness! This makes me happy. Okay, let's make some pathways through here. Maybe we can even sneak a road, actually. Oh my goodness, I was totally not planning on doing this, but this is a great idea. Okay, looks like we're stuck doing just pedestrian pathways only. Which is fine. So that'll go like this. That'll go like that. This is so neat. Awesome. And it looks like this just slightly made a bridge for whatever weird reason. I guess the ground here is a little bit just slightly off. Oh well. Still works, I think. Oh, weird. I have to do that, eh? Okay, well, whatever. We'll let this area kind of do its own thing. And I'm gonna put in some more trees and this and that, too. Okay. Now to jazz up this area. This is too cool. I really like this. Alright, so these were a nice... tree to use. It's kind of like an oak tree. Let's do a nice line of these. Maybe on that side as well. There, nice and simple. Oh, that's cool. I wonder if we might maybe need some more parking. Gosh, this thing is so neat. Whoever did the design for the asset, like, look at how crisp that looks. And for those of you that have never been to the CN Tower, there's actually a restaurant that rotates. So this outer part where all the windows are, that rotates really, really slowly. So it takes about an hour and 20 minutes, I think, to do a full rotation. But the idea is you go up and you get a really slow rotating view of the city as you're eating your dinner. And it, like, you don't get motion sick or anything like that. It's just really, really, it's very pleasant. And it takes you a while to get up there by the elevator. You know, it's kind of, it's a fast moving elevator too, so. And I don't think we can see it, because I don't think the game is done like that. But just below, underneath here, underneath this little part, there's one section where it's all just big plexiglass panels. And so you can see the whole way down. You can stand on that, and people are like, you know, they go crazy. They get so nervous, right? And then if you, you know, walk over and jump, all the tourists kind of, you know, they freak out. But it's, I mean, it's fun. I like it. Oh my gosh, that is so gorgeous. Oh, that's beautiful. It's like the music is just, you know, set for this moment right here too. I love it. Yeah, the glass floor is what they call it. Such a fun... I mean, I don't know, I really like doing just touristy stuff in my own city. Because it just... You know, most people, they just don't do that. They don't even think to do it. Why not though, right? Okay, so park space, very good addition, guys. Who was that? That was JBS who gave us, I think, the first suggestion for that. Appreciate that. Alright, so back to some parks here. Oh, of course this doesn't fit, of course. No, that does though. Now, we'd use some of these elsewhere, but I guess that's not going to fit, so we don't have to worry. And then with these letters, we can do like a Rock Valley, kind of like Hollywood style sign somewhere in the city or in the hills or something. Like there's totally nothing stopping us from doing that. Wow, does that fit? It does in both spots. Match made in heaven. What? What? Look at that. Ah, I love it. Oh my goodness, guys. So simple, but so just like perfect. Okay, we'll do some more of those oak trees over here. This is cool. I'm not just saying it because I'm the mayor, but I would totally live here. You guys would as well, but... This city is awesome! Oh, I love it. Okay. Let's fill this area in here. Now, realistically, I think we'll need, or I think we should have some more parking lots right here. Okay, let's see for spacing what some are going to look like. Or if not parking lots, then maybe like a big park or something, right? The parking lots around it. Ooh, okay, that could work. No, I need something large and in charge. I'm gonna use these ones. I love these parking lots. Let's just put a whole bunch of these down just for placeholder. Probably gonna use some of these too. I'm just literally placing these so I don't have to worry about grabbing them later. And okay, there's this one here. And then the flip side like that. That could work as kind of a little stepping stone there. And oh, is that the end of our music? Oh my goodness, time flies. Time flies when you're having fun, right? Get onto our next little track. Alright. And I'm hoping to fit... Oh, it'd be kind of neat, actually, if we do this. Oh! Interesting idea. Interesting. Oh, and you can see... Oh, I wish we had one... Oh, if that went in by one more... Ah, darn it, darn it, darn it. Can we make that happen? I don't think so, so I'm not gonna bother. That's gonna be way too much effort for not that big of a reward, right? Oh, darn it! That'd be so cool if we could fit two of those in there, but one is still more than enough. That's awesome. All about the little things, you know? So we'll go like that. I don't think those will fit. No, they won't. So we're going to use smaller parking lots now, which is also no problemo. And I think these ones here should be, oh yeah, very, very appropriate. Now I want all the fences to face the same direction, just for symmetrical purposes. Great, and then we'll just put in some of those oak trees, just in the other spots here. I really am a fan of oak trees, to be honest, right now. Nice shade of green. Cool! Alright! Very nice, right? This is cool. Okay, what do we got right over here? Oh, how do you even know how to pronounce that? What is that? The Nicenula Observation Tower? That's kind of neat. That's really cool, actually. In Toronto, you can go up to here, the observation deck. That's as far as you can go. And you can walk on the outside. Let's see if I can get this just right. So you guys may have heard of this. There's an attraction in Toronto. It's called Edge Walk. And you literally walk, oh gosh, see if I can get that just right. Right on the top outside rail of this thing right here. And they have like harnesses and stuff and they strap you in. And you can kind of lean back like this if you want and just, you know, kind of let your heart kind of fall out of your butt type feeling. But pretty wild. Imagine like doing a base jump off this. Holy smokes, that'd be insane. Okay. I have to say, our city is coming together quite nicely, guys. This area here, pretty cool. CN Tower, a lovely addition. A unexpected surprise. I would like to use some of these parking lots. I know parking lots aren't exactly sexy, but they are important in a city nonetheless. And the bonus here is that these things act as a park. So we get like, you know, a double kind of effect from them. Okay, so we'll do that. Stretch this road. And then some offices, say right here. And then I'm gonna do some lower tier commercial, just not to spoil the view over here, you know? And then what for this spot, I wonder? Keep it open or maybe just a little bit of zoning? Maybe just like, you know, a few buildings? Like that, you know? Does that work? I think so. There are some gaps in between. Cool. I like it. Sky Tower Auckland? Oh, I would love to do like a Sky Tower slash, you know, like kind of little tour of the world just going from one place to the next type thing. The world we live in, there's some really cool spots and some like great geography and just really well thought up buildings. And it's like arguably such a great time to be alive because, you know, things like the internet and stuff, right? You can just see all of it. You can plan and it's just, I don't know, it's just, it's fun. I imagine how much challenging, or more challenging it would have been to, you know, to see and, you know, visit these places and just do things. Great time to be alive. I think all generations kind of say that, you know, it's the best time to be alive. No other generations, they don't know. Like, what do they know, right? Oh, you know what'd be really pretty is having, oh man. Okay. Clearly you can see what I'm about to do here. I don't know if she'll fit though. Not quite. Lady Liberty, let's get her in here. Hey, Aquatic Gamer, thanks for stopping by. How are you doing today? We're just about to put the Statue of Liberty in to kind of accent our coastline. And I think that might maybe be just enough terraforming. Not even close. Oh my gosh, this is a big building. If this does not look at all right, just in terms of like proportions, I might maybe put this on one of the islands or so. Kind of see how it looks on the coast though. And I think we might slightly maybe have to change that road, possibly. We'll see. That's not the worst. Okay, that does fit now. So if we go like this, yeah, that's not so bad. But would she do better, though, like on... Oh, even over here! Oh, if we move this stuff. Oh, Yeah, I've got a mod to get rid of the pollution and that kind of stuff, which is why I don't really see any of those clouds or, you know, purple ground textures. Okay, so we're gonna have to move our water pumps, that means, but I think we should put the Statue of Liberty on this little island. I think that's a fun idea. So this is gonna be a temporary move for our water collection. I'll just move them just slightly up the hill type thing and across the bank. Because I would like to make like a just like a big kind of area for this, but I want to unlock some more spots first, so I'm not really, you know, too concerned just yet. Okay. Easy peasy. We'll just wire this up rather quickly. Still my favorite noise in this game, forever and ever till the end of time. I should build a little island for... Yeah, right? Well, terraform will do... Actually, it should fit over here, I think. We'll have one little bridge kind of coming over, too, which should be really quaint. Just gotta make sure we don't block any of the shipping lanes. Oh, darn it. Darn it, of course. Okay, so we'll have to build our bridge. Oh, goodness. Tall enough. Or the bridge will have to come from the backside, because we're not gonna be blocking shipping lanes that way. Oh, boy. Oh boy. Okay, well, let's go like this. Go like that. That's fine, bummy. And then this can just kind of wind, say, through here. And then we'll just do a really simple to start diamond interchange over here. And this is just, like, literally the most simple thing imaginable. So 9. So I can get the directions here, hopefully nice and straight. Perfect. And we'll bring that down at a length of 12 units. Oops. There we go. Perfect. Build a tunnel? Oh, that's actually not a bad idea. Could we do it though? Tunnels are tricky sometimes when you're going under. Okay, let's see if we can go from here. That's a good idea, though. Because usually you run into issues with the slope or whatever, right? And they don't really want to be built on water. Oh, but you know what we could do? I'm just going to try. This might not be where it's going to be, but... We could theoretically go from, say, here... Oh yeah, this would work. And then, yeah, this would totally work. Oh, we could do both, actually. Like a tunnel and a bridge. Tunnel on one side, bridge on the other. Oh yeah, let's do that. Okay, so we'll make that work. But now we know it works, right? So let's pick a better spot. But okay, this is cool. I'm glad you guys are suggesting this. This is good. Good little team here. Okay, now I'm gonna remove this. We'll go like that as our approach angle. And the longer we stretch that out, the better. Because then it doesn't look too chaotic in terms of the slope. And okay, you can kind of see it does have slope issues. So you gotta usually build these in segments. And I run into the same kind of problems when I'm doing like, you know, subways and that kind of stuff underwater as well, right? But it looks like mission accomplished. Okay, now if we do this correctly, we should be able to kind of follow the length of the or the shoreline of the island here. Nice, okay. And then we can build ourselves a park and a few other things over here, as well as the Statue of Liberty. Cool. Is that too... I don't know, that might be a little bit too insane. Let's try
try backing that up. No, I think we actually have to back both of these up. I think that's kind of the secret here. I should go a little bit further with the tunnel, you think? Oh yeah, I saw that link to do local ferries and local connections, like that kind of stuff. I was thinking of maybe tackling that, just like, you know, again off camera, if I can get kind of familiar with it, and then doing it within the city itself. So I think that can be probably fixed in terms of the heights. That's better. Oh, almost, not quite. I don't mind if some of this becomes a bridge. I just don't want it to be a weird kind of shaped event over here, you know? Maybe alternatives. I see. No, that's not really it. I want to kind of hug the ground a little bit better here. Yeah, the ferry thing, it seems like it'd be something that would be available in the game. Interesting that there has to be a mod, you know? Okay, well, I really don't want that road to be like that, but I'm just not going to be too finicky right now, so we'll just kind of let that be. And where are you, my friend? There we are. Okay, now this is what I was kind of worried about. We might need a flat kind of thing first. Or not flat, like straight, you know, for reference or whatever. There we go. Oh yes! Perfect! That just barely fit. Awesome! Yes! This is totally what I was after though. This is cool. Okay. Maybe the trick to doing back here is to landscape this a bit. I think that might maybe be what we're after here. Oh, I think I said that right as you typed it out. Great minds think alike. Perfection! Cool stuff. Okay, let's put some parking lots in over here. Let's do some terraforming for us, so our parking lots aren't all crazy. Maybe we can lower that a bit. Oh, I love this part of the song. You know what? I think in terms of the best approach, we need this to be tall and even, don't we? I think that's our best game plan. Yeah, we don't need to use all of those. I think maybe two is more than enough. There we go. And then this can be a plaza. Possibly, if we move this over. I think we just needed one extra square there. Cool. Yeah, that works for me. And I would like to do some just pedestrian pathways kind of lining. Ah, darn it, we're not going to be able to do that though, are we? That's fine. Okay, well then let's put in some more trees. Just kind of fill in that little back spot there. Not the end of the world. And I'm going to use the same style that are pretty much in the asset itself, so that's a nice little blend. And we're going to get a little bit of that color kind of effect happening just because of the shoreline. For whatever reason, it acts like pollution in regards to the trees here. And then this leads me to think that this is like, you know, if a modder wanted to, this would be a precursor for introducing actual seasons into the game. Because I know that with snowfall, a lot of people are expecting, you know, like dynamic changing weather, like you go from spring to summer, like that kind of stuff, right? And then at the peak of that whole fiasco, I don't want to call it a fiasco, that's really not what it was at all, but there was a few modders that talked about, they were saying, oh yeah, it should be possible, you know, given this and this, right? So, nothing's impossible. Maybe we can zone over here too, just get some people kind of coming around, you know? I was like, why in the heck is there pipes over here already? But of course, this is where our water used to be. Oh my goodness. Oh, a tram over to here? Oh my gosh, that would be so... I don't know if we have enough people to justify that yet, but I'm not opposed to that idea for later on. To upgrade one of the, like, this road here type thing to the tram track road. Actually, I don't know, why not, right? Why not? Yeah. We could do it. Where's the tram going to come from? I guess underground, right? Okay, let's do it. Why not? Why the heck not? I would like to have... It'd be kind of cool to have a power generator over here. Otherwise, we have to bring some power lines over, which is not exactly... Not exactly sexy. Now, what if we did this? No, we're so close! What about... Oh, we're so close. Little utility boxes, that kind of stuff. Well, I guess there's no harm, really. We could do this. Oh. Oh, there we go. So that powers that. And then, heck, why not? Let's do our little tram line. I think, though, we're just going to come from the tunnel. I think that's a better way to do things here. Guys, this is such a cute idea. Oh, good, we can't. Okay, good. I say, unless we can't, but we can. Alright, defaults. Back above grounds. And just do this for simplicity. Back to the old upgrader. Nice. Okay, so that breaks off of that. It goes over to our island. And then... it's such a fun... This is a great idea. Oh, no, our parking lot's got a little bit warped. Maybe we can take that one out, keep just one parking lot, and then, you know what would be kind of cool is if we had maybe like one taller building over here. Although we're not quite getting the right squares. Let's say like one, you know, like one 3x3 like that, and then one even like a 4x4, right? Or a 4x3 I should say. I wish we'd go with the extra a little bit back there, but... And we'll just see what that looks like, and then we'll just zone this a little bit. And then in regards to the terraforming, because now that that's a little bit odd, right? I'm going to smoothen some things out here. Oh, the ferries in the transport tab? I don't have that mod installed, right? So you'll just kind of see I don't have the... It just won't really show up, right? But, I think I have it downloaded, just maybe not turned on. I think that's kind of the case where I'm at. Okay, so that's that. Let's put in our little tram line over here. Yeah, it's such a cute idea. Where are we going to come from, I wonder? Because like, we really should figure out where our central hub is going to be for, you know, for transportation, right? I really haven't picked that out yet. So over here, you guys can notice, I downscaled the train station. I thought the other one was a little bit too big to maybe use, per se, in this part of the city. I think if we do, like, an actual downtown, kind of like, say... I mean, we are going to eventually open up this whole map, right? I was thinking maybe over in here, we could do, like, a bigger downtown-style kind of place. Like another university campus and some other, you know, other stuff. Okay, so let's, so maybe what we could do is, have like a little transportation kind of thing over here. And then what we can do just simply, and upgrade that like this, go over to our trams tab, what am I looking for here, right this way. And then with this, we'll take one ways. And we'll just go on a series of diagonals like this. And these can be, you know, kind of like tram bays. Think of them like that, right? So passengers would queue here, they wait for the trams to kind of show up, and then gets to all parts of the city, you know? Let's do a better job spacing this last one. A little bit foil for the last one, looks like. Okay, well, we'll just put in that many, because that's more than enough. Just take out these things here. Oops. Make sure there's no traffic lights. Perfect. I'm seeing a little bit of foil for the last one, looks like. Okay, well, we'll just put in that menu, because that's more than enough. Just take out these things here. Oops. Make sure there's no traffic lights. Perfect. And then this could be changed. It could be a work in progress. We don't know just yet. We'll probably work a subway in. But for the moment, let's just maybe have this as placeholder. Or just something in this same kind of idea can work, you know, maybe elsewhere. But the idea is you start your line over here. Let's go this way. It's just like a big central terminal, right? So all the trains, all the trams, all the subways, all the buses, they all eventually meet over there. Okay, so we're cutting through here. Interesting enough, we don't actually make any stops along this way. So we're not going to get too much line sharing, unfortunately, unless we remove some of those other stops. Which is something we totally could do. Because like everything else in the city, nothing is set in stone. Okay, so just come on over to our islands. And I guess we're fine just really going the one direction over here. And we'll just come back like this. What a nice little line this is, eh? This is kind of fun. I like this. Very good. And you can kind of see all the buildings leveling up. This is all the direct result of the streetcars going in. So public transit, if done correctly, is worth its weight in gold as far as your citizens are concerned. Okay, let's color this. And it looks like we have some people here complaining about the noise, which I can't say that I'm surprised. So we'll get rid of this, and we're going to change this over to offices. And then that might hopefully act as a buffer in between kind of our noisy train station here on the roads and stuff. Alright, what do we got over here? Let me just take a look at this thing. Oh, that's kind of... Oh, that's so neat. That actually is Main Street. That's so funny. I'll keep that one open. I'm not going to subscribe to anything new just yet until I kind of do some, you know, tinkering as to how many more assets I can hold. That's a cool looking station, right? The TTC, it has some fun infrastructure. I like Toronto. Okay, so can we see one of these trams in action? That'd be so cool. Oh, yeah, people are actually driving over here. All right, well, let's finish our little exchange on this part of the world. So this is just like one lane by one lane, like, you know, it's like single lane access. It's not exactly too much happening over here. This is essentially as basic as we could make it, but diamond interchange that we have now back access to our city and to our island. And this can be scaled up very easily eventually. Bigger lanes, like that kind of stuff, right? This is cool! Let me get rid of some of this trees here because of that anarchy mod. There. That's kind of fun. Yeah, I saw those new tram terminals. I think I maybe have one downloaded. They're in props' decorations, so I'm not 100% where they ended up. They're just like ploppable buildings, right? I really have no idea where to look for them, unfortunately, but oh, they should be there. Okay, well, let's hang out here until we see a tram. Oh, actually, something else that I was tempted to do. Let me bring the sun down. Do we need any more lighting over here? Because we do have the ability to drop in some, like, you know, some red or like that kind of stuff, right? Is that taboo, I wonder? Just kind of throw a few of these in. I don't know, it's not so bad, right? I don't know. Let's keep it, sure. Let's keep it. Why not? Just for fun, right? Okay, any trams poking their heads through yet? Actually, I don't know. I'm not really feeling this red. I don't know. So much of like a red light kind of district feel now. Okay, now watch me not be able to find... There. It's like the tiniest little asset imaginable. There we go. Yeah, I think it's better without the red lighting. Maybe we could try blue. White lighting is kind of nice though, just on its own. Blue. Oh yeah, I think blue is a little bit nicer. This I will keep. Red was a little bit too intense. Too loud. Cool. And then I'm sure we can maybe benefit from a few more buildings, say right here. And I see trams! Look at that! That's so cool. Actually, maybe that's not in the best spot. Maybe those like that. Oh wow, this is so cool. It's just so simple, but just so awesome. Like trams on an island. Like, I don't know, that's such a cool concept, right? Why is it so... Oh, red, white, and blue. Oh, of course. Of course. That we can definitely do. Yes. Put these double up. Absolutely, we can do that. That's a great idea. There we go. Now that is nice together. So now we got the red, white, and blue. There we go. Oh yeah, that's a really nice little mix together. That's cool. Very good, guys. Quite nice. Alright, now what do we do with this terraform spot here? Maybe we should just kind of bring this back in. Okay, so population, we really haven't actually made that much of a dent this whole episode. Or this whole stream, I should say. So let's maybe spend like 10 or 20 minutes just trying to get a few more residential neighborhoods kind of filled in. But otherwise, I'm going to have to end the stream soon because it's already 2.5 hours, which is great. It's just I unfortunately have to start getting ready for that YouTube thing tonight. Okay, so we'll hide that a little bit. Just kind of leave that be for the moment. That's so cool. One more time over here now that the daylight's up. Very fun. Now, I wonder if anyone's actually using this back way yet. Probably not. There's like no reason to, you know, but... And we're not disrupting the boats, which is also a bonus. Very fun. Gosh, very fun. I should put the red, white, and blue around the CN Tower, too. I wish I could put some colors up on top. Let's see how that looks at night. Oopsies. Too many clicks. Okay, let's do the same thing over here. Okay, so we got our red. And we got our blue. Oh, actually, that looks nice over here, too. It kind of has like a little, you know, that kind of purpley light kind of actually spilling out. So good on the game physics for creating, you know? Yeah, it's a nice little addition, right? Too bad it doesn't go further up the tower, though. In terms of the spotlighting height, right? See how it's kind of lost just right on the base right there? Oh, but that's a cool freaking view too. Whoa, with the sky going. Man, look at that, eh? That's kind of neat. I like that. Alright, so sunlight. What happened over here? I guess we didn't really finish. Maybe this can be just high density, just to change that up a bit. Cool. And then how did things end up over here in our new little... Yeah, I guess it filled in. I wish we had a little bit more room to work with over in these spots, but... These areas, to me, they just seem like they're ready more for parks and rocks and like that kind of stuff versus more buildings, you know? Yeah, I know, because we have some pretty... Like the LED lighting for the CN Tower in real life, it's got some pretty cool patterns and colors, so it's a shame we don't get that over the same effect happening over here, but oh well. Alright, so just simply, because I know this is going to change, let's just do some zoning just off these little roads here. So all we need really is just a few more towers, and then we need those to kind of level up, and then we can get, you know, a few thousand people at each one type thing. Maybe not a few thousand, but you know what I mean, right? A good number. Okay, so let's go like that, just to get some more of those in. Otherwise, I think we'll start with doing the next stream, but we could start moving over here and maybe making some like suburbs and those foothills, and we can expand on some of our trains, and then we can start doing some buses and stuff too. We got so much we want to do in the city still. Okay, so we get some more zoning, I think, over here. We'll go like this. then let's make ourselves just like a few neighborhoods literally connected to this thing here. And if we can get the right angle, it should look kind of cool through here. That's not quite it. There it is. Okay, now I don't know if we're gonna get lucky with this. We can try, because I want this to connect right over here. Oh yeah, we can. And then I would love for this to work. But that's not the way I want it to happen, though. Okay, let's try this a little bit different way. Perfect. There, we'll do that instead. Okay, I mean, really so simple, right? Pretty good use of the internal zoning squares, though, which is kind of what I was after. I think this can be too noisy for people there, so I'm gonna put a little barrier of some commercial. And then we'll try our luck with some residential zoning right there. But it's the same idea, we might end up being a little bit too noisy overall. And, you know, possibly some more commercial. Maybe not on that part, though. Just back that up a little bit. There we go. And some hide-and-seek commercial right here. I mean, obviously, like, the more you tackle these demands, right, like, the more, you know, residents we get in. So if we put in a lot of commercial and a lot of, you know, like, businesses, factories, that kind of stuff, our commercial demand, you can even see it's already, or residential demand will go up. That's already starting to happen. Okay, so I think before we end things off, let's sneak a peek at services, and we'll let some of these buildings kind of populate. I'm actually just curious to see our... Yeah, you can kind of see, like, we have a really old population. So, like, we're going to be going through another death wave soon, so we're kind of going in a big circle almost with our population, right? But it still steps in the right direction. Oh, Cool Cat Candy, see you later. Thanks for stopping by. I'll see you on Sunday, hopefully, for the stream then. The power, we're doing really well. Sewage, you know, we know that's the issue. Water pumping is totally fine, but we'll just kind of build ourselves like another area like this, but somewhere else in the city. Just using some of these, you know, custom ones here, right? And we have a whole bunch of like clarifiers and like this kind of stuff, so we can build ourselves some really cool, kind of like purposeful utility areas. And then, you know, encompass like garbage and that kind of stuff, right? Garbage collection isn't so bad. I would like to put something over here, though. It generates its own power, that's fine. Let's bring pipes over. I don't even think that it needs water, to be honest, but... That way we get some garbage collection happening, you know, on this part, and it should hopefully serve just the lower area here, right? There, that's kind of cool. Okay, so healthcare. Not too shabby. I think we actually knew this was pretty good anyway. Fire coverage, we also know, is not too bad. This is an issue. Oh boy, I didn't consider that, right? So maybe a little fire station here. That should be more than enough. And then policing, by that same argument, we could put something tiny. Like one of these little rural stations, right? Yeah, that's fine for me. Make our tourists feel safe. Education, a little bit all over the place. Definitely this area here could use a boost. High school, I say it's better. Like, and for these areas here, you can see the coverage is good. It's just like these would be newer residents, right? They haven't really lived here long enough to, you know, have been educated yet. I'm not going to worry too much about university coverage throughout the whole city, just because I know we're going to be adding in another university eventually, but maybe just like a community college or two, just kind of throughout here. Just in a couple spots, right? And those are just, you know, you can't really tell they're universities, right? But you get the university kind of benefit. Where can this go that's not too intrusive? That's fine right there. And then maybe one just up here as well, right? Move that slightly center. There we go. There we go. Okay. That's good for education. Transportation, we got a lot to do with this, let's put it that way. But, you know, we'll be working on that, I think, next stream. And then parks also, we don't have the worst coverage, but there are some areas that just don't have anything, right? So we're going to have to go through, and even if it's just a matter of just going, say, like this, dropping in something that just fits, you know, say, like right here, for example. Because even that just has a really big positive influence, right? So we can just do that a few times throughout the city just to get some more, you know, just generically more parks in. But I think our main goal should just be to kind of get the population up, unlock some more squares, and then we can start doing some more customization. We can just build with a little bit more purpose. We can kind of, you know, stretch some more highways through and just start doing some of the, just the bigger infrastructure planning. Oh, Pertlik, I'm glad you enjoyed the stream. I will see you in the next one. Take care of yourself. Okay, so let's do some cinematic, scenic views of our city here. Gosh, the CN Tower, what a great idea. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I said, I'm not 100% on the lighting down here. That might maybe have to go, just because you don't get enough of the tower lit up, but otherwise, what a great, like, oh, cool the city looks, guys. Holy smokes. That's awesome. The Statue of Liberty over there. Really coming along nicely. And this is cool too, like the harbor. Not a lot of train yards, but this was kind of fun. Feels like forever ago we were working on this, right? Just adding these little lines of trains in. Seemed like that was a lot of work. Not too bad though. Some more factory space has finally come in and filled in. Looks kind of cool at the hills too, actually. Minus the fact that some of these parking lots are a little bit crooked in our offices, but that's alright. And I wonder how many people are using our train line here, is out of curiosity. Okay, so it's not too many. But as the population grows, hopefully that'll get better, right? Oh, Siberia, thanks. Yeah, this isn't really the city, it's coming along nicely. Like I'm actually surprisingly, I would say surprisingly impressed. But this map, I was actually doing a time lapse on this, and I was building an entirely different city, and I still have that saved, but with the whole issue with the whole anarchy mods, I just stopped working on it. So I built something entirely different, but this is slowly becoming like a really, really, really cool place. Like definitely cool, and I'm loving the little canal system we have around our university. Definitely digging the arch right here. Huge fan of this, holy smokes, especially with the trams, and oh my goodness, how cool that is. Another TTC icon right there, or asset I should say. So yeah, we'll be streaming again this coming Sunday. I don't know when, it's holiday weekend here in Canada. I probably got some family stuff or whatnot to do, right? But stay tuned on Twitter, we'll probably sneak in a stream of, you know, 2 or 3 hours in length. Just kind of continue with our, you know, our city. Also another fun little area here, our little magic roundabout. It's courtesy of the Squirrel Army Studios YouTube channel, you should look them up. Got a few City Skylines videos. Alright, well I think that's pretty much it, guys. Yeah, I've definitely lived in this city. And so, what I was thinking, so the city, as you guys know, is called Rock Valley. Like, even these hills right here, we could do like a Hollywood-style sign. Like, I've got all of the lettering, right? You can see I've got this already in place, right? So we can light it up, make it seem like it's a Hollywood-style sign, and that'd be kind of fun, I think, right? Or we could do that in, like, one of the other hills, maybe, like, over here. Kind of see how the city grows, but... That's it. So, yeah, I'll see you guys on Sunday. Stop on by for another stream. Hit the subscribe button if you guys want to. Check me out on YouTube as well. I'll be posting this stuff over to YouTube. Oh, Squirrel Army, you are here, too. Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah, no, of course. I won't forget you. Still, like, just look at this again. This is still one of the coolest things, right? Very clever. Good on you for figuring this out. I just love seeing the trams go through here. Like, it's such a fun piece of infrastructure. And this, I don't know, I just love that, you know, the high density is all built up around it finally. You know, got some trees going there too, and hills and stuff all around. I don't know, the city, it's really starting to have a nice feel to it. You almost feel like you're kind of home now. Oh, my pleasure. I appreciate you coming here. Thanks for spending your day with me, guys. Wish I could stream for longer. There we go. Nice pleasant city, right? God, the CN Tower is so empowering. I love it. Hoo-yah! Very strong man, right? Oh, my goodness. Well, thanks for saying that, Dan. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care of yourselves. I look forward to reading all the comments on the YouTube section, so stop on by there. has any suggestions there, you know, totally feel free to make them. Just in terms of assets, that kind of stuff too, feel free to keep posting them. I have to slow down though with, I don't know if I can add any new ones. I'll have to, you know, erase quite a few before I start adding some new ones, right? But we'll see. Yeah, we'll see. I can hopefully add a few more. But no, today it was a great stream, guys. I had a lot of fun. Like, I love this. The Statue of Liberty and the CN Tower alone are just, they totally made the stream perfect for me. And it's such a fun little island. Like, it's so simple, but just so pleasant. Love it. Alright, guys, well, I will see you in the next one. I always, my goodbyes, they take me forever. Gosh, 2 hours, 40 minutes, that's a good stream. I really thought we would just stream for like 2 hours today, so that's really good. Okay, guys, take care of yourselves. I'll see you in the next one. Adios.